All right, looks like we're live. So thank you for waiting. Mike Jordan was ready since day one. Sleepy's here. 808 Dino, do you need to download something to join or just confirm email? Just confirm. You get free downloads just for hopping into the giveaway. It just makes it so everybody wins, even if you don't win. So it's my way of just making you not feel like crap. Mars Net, what's up? Jetwan is here. Gorgeous Singh, what's up? Jetwan, how do I enter? Go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. We're going to pick a winner Friday, which is tomorrow at 9 p.m. Eastern time. We're going to do it live. All right. So I just wanted to make sure you had the link because I haven't been promoting it as much because I haven't been on socials as much. How do you say that? Cola Cut. What's up? Cola Cut Beats. Probably saying that wrong. Or Cold Cut. Cold Cut Beats. 9x19mm, what's up? Castro's here. You want FL Studio? All I gotta do is just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. The link's in the video description. We're gonna pick the winner live tomorrow. And we're gonna get the winner straight from ImageLine. You're gonna get the FL Studio. Eric, what's up? So I was trying to download sounds and it was 18 gigs, so it took a minute and then it dropped the download. At the very end, it was like, download couldn't work. So I'm trying to get my sounds from my folders so that I don't have to use stock sounds. So without further ado, I'm just going to copy one of the folders over because I couldn't download everything. I was trying to download all my friends' stuff, but it is what it is. I'll have to do that at a different time. It just didn't mess up. Feedback, yeah, that will be tomorrow as well. My bad. Everybody joined in when I had my head turned. Walshy is here. I hope I win. There you go. Good attitude. Briefcakes. Briefcase. Oh, I get it. Set a briefcase. Briefcakes. That is funny. Baga Beat CLB is back. What's up? Sid the Sloth. Any suggestions on how to make my interface not click as much even after messing with my latency? Well, your latency is your number one thing as far as clicking. If you're talking about static, it's just your room. You can't undo that. It's your microphone. It's your room. It's the electricity. It's too much work for an average person to do. You have to get like discrete electricity, discrete outlets and all this. But that's all I can think of as far as latency, as far as clicking and crackling. Or maybe your computer just can't handle that much. It might be your computer. It just can't handle a lot. It shouldn't be a static problem on the mic. It should be a computer problem. What up? Cameron's here. What's going on? Down One's here. Triple X is here. Giorgio Doran. I won FL. I like the attitude. Junior Lyles. What's up? Busy Works Beats. I'm trying to preserve my voice so I can't exert so much energy. But shout out if you're watching this on a replay. We're just getting started here. Again, we're going to give away FL Studio for the next 2 weeks, at least the next 2 weeks. So to enter, just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. The link's in the video description. We pick the winner live on YouTube. It's not a bull crap contest. We get the versions of FL directly from ImageLine. So it's no shady stuff. Let me join the live chat on my phone so I can keep up. Give me a moment here. I'm trying to charge my phone, join the live. Wait, are we live? I don't see the live stream. Oh, here it is. Okay. Belgium is here. Yeah, where are you guys from? Let me know. I'll shout out your country. Oops, wrong tab. Hold up. But shout out to everybody who joined. Mask is here. I'm going to quickly say what's up to everybody. Junior's here. What's up? Mask is here. Jensen is here. It's going pretty well. Epix is here. Epix Animations. Andre Marias. What's up? Creative Music Studio. I'm chilling, man. Trying to live life. Zabie is here. What's up? Street Gossip. What's up, man? Produced by Elusive says, will you email the winner? Because I'm probably not going to be able to watch tomorrow's stream. Yeah, the winner is emailed, but if you got to claim your prize within 24 hours because I don't want to sit around all week waiting for you to reply. So that's the rules. Nicolo Dedico. What's up? Oh, dang, my chat refreshed. Can I read this fast? Let's see if I can read it before. Where'd I? Okay. All right, we're about to get into it in about 2 seconds, guaranteed. Russian letters, I can't pronounce that, but it's up to you. Defrex, Classy Beats is here, what's up? Mike Boylek, the system, what do you mean? Skrelly, what's up? Double Y Creation, Sons of X. If you need to download packs to enter, no, just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio and you're automatically entered once you sign up. Those are just free downloads, if just because I want people to feel like they're actually getting something instead of just signing up for something. And even if you win or not. So Shaw Crow Dash Shabby. Yeah, hilarious. The Beat Link, what's up? Yuku Nurk, what's up? Marlo, what's up? Your Instagram. Oh, thank you for watching the Instagram stories. Yeah, I'm trying to do a daily thing. I'm trying to build like new habits, and I've been writing a lot and reading a lot, so I have to apply what I'm actually learning. So that's what the IG stories are really from. Ronnie FTC Belgium is here too. There we go. Leon, I need FL Studio. I'm 16. Don't got much money. Okay. Platinum plug. Scar Beats, what you cooking up? Today we're gonna be finally making beats that sound like beats instead of stock plugin stuff, because I've imported my sounds from some of my sounds from my friend's folder. Now I tried to download the whole folder, but it didn't work, so I have to do it again. But I don't want to waste time on the live stream doing it again, so because it will hinder the stream quality. So I have to, I'll do it later. Okay, but I have enough loops and drums. We should be able to get through it today. So we're going to make as many tracks as I can. More R&B stuff. If we get in the trap, we'll get in the trap. But it's going to be guitar-based R&B. Oh, I didn't have to... let me see if I can quickly unzip these. I love how Mac just unzips it. You don't have to do all this stuff. There we go. All right, good. Okay, so now we have that. Make sure my drums are open. So my friend Hef, he runs a company called Drumify, and do I have number 6 in here? Are you joking? Oh my goodness, my favorite kit isn't in the. I didn't upload it, so I don't know what kit 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1 are, but hopefully they have good sounds in it. Shout out to Big White Beats, Big White Beats. If you watch, or if anybody knows Big White Beats, please tell them to hit me up some type of way. And we got to collab on like a drum kit. That'd be dope. All right, so that's that. Okay, so I should have some trap drums, some more modern drums. I have to refresh the chat. I thought I could keep up, but the chat was going too fast. Italy is here. We're about to get rocking in 3 seconds. Brazil's here. Austria's here. Ethiopia. There we go. Portugal. Are you going to make a video of the giveaway? Yeah, tomorrow we'll do it live. And I'll send out emails to the winner, or one email to the winner. I loaded up FL. I have a template and I forgot to turn it off, the reverb. What are your favorite Electra banks? I don't really use Electra. I have it, but I don't use it. Expand is only $20. Wow. Can you do more drill tutorials? We could do drill today, I guess. When did you get a Mac? When did I get a Mac? Maybe 2 weeks ago, or 2 weeks ago, probably. It's mainly to test my software. Okay. South Africa is here, Ireland here, UK is here, Finland here, New York. All right, let's get it rocking. Morocco's here. Cool. So NFL. So I have to look at my chat on my phone because I can't dual screen here. So I'm trying to charge my phone, read the chat, and make beats at the same time. France, what's up? France is in the building. Oh yeah, Big Drew is here. What up? Forgive me for skipping the whole. I had to refresh the chat. It skipped a lot. So let's refresh. And let's start with some guitar loops. So I'm going to actually be making beats that I'm going to probably actually use. This isn't going to be like a tutorial so much, more so looking over my shoulder. Nexus, I have it, but I don't use it that much. Now these kits are a little hard to hear, so I have to turn up my headphones. So these sounds are from 7-foot G. They were recorded exclusively for me and Sine. Whenever that project's coming out, I don't know, but I'm gonna work on these beats regardless. So let's go to here. So these are exclusives, you can't get this on a website. So the style was for Summer Walker, it was for Kalani, it was for, what's the name, Janae Aiko. So I'm trying to see what kind of drums we could add to it. So once you have loops, you know, it's pretty much half done. Let's just go to time stretch mode. And I'll show you little hacks I use to get stuff done faster. Let's hit Option or Alt. Zoom in on your mouse wheel. And let's drag that in. Zoom out. Go to your top left. Let's go to channel settings. Go to mode. Let's go to stretch mode. Now you just make sure it just lines up with your metronome. Now one thing about his recording, he didn't mix these fully, which is good. That means I get to mix it. So what I'm going to do, I don't have my Isotope stuff. I should install FabFilter on here at least, but it just needs a little bit of low-end EQ'd out. You don't have to obsess during the beat-making process about mixing. As long as you get it creatively sitting right, you should be all right, because when you take it to Pro Tools or whatever you actually record in, that's when you start mixing anyway, or remixing it. So we just need the general vibe from here. So I'm gonna tame the lows a little bit. Let's send this to the reverb. Reverb's kind of like the secret for R&B. So it adds the emotion. We don't need to add, I don't have my, let me see if I scan for a Cooper Time Cube. Wait, instead of, what was the plugin I just said? I forgot. So let's add Cooper Time Cube. I forgot what other plugin I just mentioned 2 seconds ago. Oh, the Isotope. Let me see if there's a UA equivalent. So this just widens out the guitar. You can use FL Studio Stereo Enhancer. Make a crunk beat. I'll try to sing, but these guitar loops were made specifically for Sine Waller, which is a singer, and myself. We were gonna do a joint album. And these were recorded specifically for her vocal range. So In the Mind of Jhené Aiko, Kalani, and who else? Summer Walker. So I'll try to hack my way through it, but it's gonna be like Party Next Door type singing, not like R. Kelly singing. Let me think, is there a parametric? Let me see if there's a better EQ that UA has. I'm not sure they have a dynamic EQ. From what I know, they could, I could be wrong. Or I could just use the channel strip, duh. Let's use the channel strip. I like the parametric EQ too from Image Line, but sometimes it just, wait, did I add it? Wait, channel strip. Hold up, let's type in SSL. Why isn't it on my list? Right, channel strip. Let's make sure we have, oh, that's the AU, no wonder, okay. BST is what I meant to click. All right, so this gives me more precise. It eats up a little bit more CPU, but it gives you more precise stuff. Again, you don't have to hardcore mix. I know the owner of Track Gods, RJ Knox. Shout out to him. He just had a kid from India. Time to help, bro. I need it. Cool. Go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. That's where we'll do the giveaway tomorrow. I just want to make sure everybody has the chance to sign up. It's free to enter. Can you explain the difference between dynamic and a parametric? Dynamic means that these knobs will do something, but moving. So for example, if I wanted something to cut out like 300 hertz and only at a certain level, so if the volume isn't loud enough, it won't work. But once the volume goes above a certain level, it will start to cut out the volume. So dynamic just means there's rules to when the EQ is applied. So this is used to really just tame sections of your song. So you hear that kind of muddy, kind of vague area, I'm just gonna cut that out. And when you cut, you wanna use more narrow bands. Again, you don't wanna obsess about mixing right now. No, I haven't heard people ask for crunk in a minute. So we're gonna boost the high highs, maybe 14K or 12K. Give it a little more top end. Feels like it's more open. I'm gonna boost 3K just to see what it sounds like. Then cut it. We don't need that much 3K. Now what I'm doing is so tame you can barely tell. So again, if you don't know how to do any of this, just exaggerate the settings so that you can hear it. I'm gonna add a compressor though. Keep the sound very tame. so it doesn't distract us with the movements. So what's the difference between a multi-band compressor and a dynamic EQ? Compressors add, they have an envelope shape. Dynamics EQs don't really have an envelope necessarily. So that's one difference with dynamic EQs versus compressors, some depending on which one. Mostly though, with a multi-band compressor, So it's kind of like asking what's the difference between EQing something and compressing something. So once you, I'm not saying that it's a bad question to ask. I'm saying that once you understand the difference between EQ and compression, that's going to give you your answer. So let's overly compress this guitar. It's not just turning down the volume, it's making it feel like it's squished. Because what it's doing is turning the quiet levels of the guitar to match the loud levels of the guitar so that it sounds completely different. Whereas a dynamic EQ just listens for when a sound goes above a certain point and then it lowers the volume. It doesn't add texture, it doesn't add this kind of squashed sound. And that's the main difference between a dynamic EQ and a multi-band. Where did you learn all this stuff about mixing? Ken Lewis teaches pretty well on Audio School Online. I learned a lot from him. Maybe there are some books you can recommend. No, not a book on mixing. You mix with your ears, not a reading it. Maybe the electronics you could learn about on paper. Signal flow you can learn on paper, but you gotta hear the stuff to learn mixing. Same with sound design. You can't learn it from a book necessarily. Okay, so now we have the guitar doing its job. It's tamed, has a vibe to it. Now, if you wanted to give it like a Party Next Door vibe, I would suggest you preserve any pitch altering stuff till the very, very, very end. But turn down your feedback, turn down your delay time, and turn up time modulation to give it that record, like the 80s record sound that everybody wants. I wouldn't recommend it for this guitar though, because he does a lot of pitch bends. So all we need to do is add simple drums. You don't need to overly complicate this. Now this would be, if Rich Hunter was here, this would be a good example of how to arrange, because I can't replay his guitar. So there's no way I can really make a B section unless I just chop it up and make it sound different. In this case, I wouldn't slow down the guitar. We could try it. Let's do that. Let's make this unique. And our main goal is to create contrast. So if we go to the top left, go to time stretch mode, drag this out. So we're at 8 bars. We need to take this up to 16. So let's just grab it to double the length. Can you make a beat? Can you make a beat and can we work together? I've seen a lot of people doing that collab with the subscribers thing. But then you have people who, you put yourself at risk, legal risk, when you do that. Is there a simple way to explain mixing and mastering? That's a very big question. It seems like a simple question. That's like saying, is there a simple way to understand the universe? It's just a lot, it's a short amount of words, but a big answer. But in short, mixing is just editing the sound to make sure that you can hear each sound. Mastering is making stuff louder. That's pretty much what it is. Mastering used to be when they would transfer the files over to a different format and all this. So mastering was a more intricate process, but now mixing is just editing the sound so that you can hear everything clearly. Mastering is making sure it's loud and that it translates. So ask the question, will this song sound good with reverse guitar? Probably not, but let's see. So here's where we need to pull out our arrangement tricks, because there's no way I can replay guitar. So we're kind of reliant on his one guitar take. So reverse doesn't sound that cool. So in that case, we're going to really have to chop it up. Or we can add like a halftime effect, or we can do filtering just to make it sound different. I mean, I'm just not looking. I mean, it sounds fun, Big Drew, don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to come at you like a person to person. I've seen other channels do the collab with their subscribers thing. It's just at the end of the day, it's a good piece of content, but what is it really doing? You know, what's the goal of that piece of content? So, I, you know, that's my main thing. It's what's the goal for the content? Anyway, let's load up some drums. Let's go to Drumify. And I don't have the one kit I want, so this is, I don't know these sounds. That's a dope kit. Okay, so we're gonna do like a London on the track type of vibe here with some trap drums. And I'll be a little bit quick because you guys have seen this a million times, how to make trap drums. But mainly just picking the right ones. Like the snap. Trying to get this thing to work right. Hold up. Also for R&B, I like to add a little bit more percussion than usual, running through some reverb. Engage subs and making beats hands-on. I just don't see the ultimate vision for that. Again, it just puts, like, okay, they're gonna ask, okay, where's the song? And it's like, if I don't like the song, then what's the point of doing it? You know what I mean? I get it. It's just, I don't want to put my brand name on stuff. That's why you got to be so careful who you work with. This is just a bigger thing I was talking about on Instagram today. Big Drew just sparked my thought. BWB and business. Yeah, that needs to happen though. You got to be careful what you put your name on and who you represent. The same way, like, entertainment lawyers are not going to take everybody as their client. I've been talking to a lot of entertainment lawyers recently, a lot of attorneys, and not everybody will pick up on people as their client for reasons. You know, it's not a personal thing, it's just a brand thing. But the people with no work, they're like, oh yeah, I need clients, so they'll take anybody. But when you're established, you don't just work with anybody. It might be a fun like stream, but again, when people are getting pissed that I'm not actually putting out the song, they're gonna be like, why didn't you put out the song? It's because I don't really want to collab with anybody. So it'd be a lie for me to even do like a what do you call it, subscriber collab, because I'm not trying to collab with anybody. So I'm trying to be honest, you know. I just don't want to create an illusion that I am trying to do that. So boom boom, but you brought up a good point that I brought up on Instagram. So I'm glad you asked. Have you ever heard you use Magic's Music Maker, and how would you compare the usability between that and FL? I liked Magic Sounds. I was actually surprised. I had it downloaded on my PC. I need to probably install it again. I liked the sounds. They were actually pretty good. It was actually a pretty good DAW for what it was. I just don't think people know about it. Nah, there's liability. You got people fighting over percentage. Like, what is the point in getting an attorney involved in like the equity of a record? There's so many little things when it comes to the business side that people forget. They think everybody's just easy to work with. I'm trying to be like as nondescriptive as possible. But one of my producer friends who's deep in the industry, very reliant on the industry, said that one time they were fighting with a producer about who laid the 808. And the producer wanted like a crazy percentage. And he's like, dog, all you did was type in an 808. And they had a big thing about it. So little stuff like that on the back end, it just is not worth the headache. That's why you got to screen who you work with before you work with them and what they represent. Because you don't want to be... you don't want to be tied to somebody else and then they do something foul or they just maneuver in a weird way and now you're tied to their image. You don't want that. It's like when Kanye worked with Lil Pump. I'm sure he regrets that. So sometimes you got to say no. Most of the time you got to say no. So we're just going to do basic trap drums. So, shout out team producer Grind. I didn't realize they go live at 6. So, my bad. I didn't know that was their live stream time. But shout out to them. So when you have a melody, record it quick so that you know how much room you're going to need. Let's record this. Okay, so now you know the vocal space you need. You can use that almost like an acapella, even though it's like me humming or whatever. You could use that as an acapella. And then this will prevent you from overly producing. A lot of younger producers or people who just make battle beats all day, they don't realize they're overly producing. And they have like 18,808 slides and everything. So some of y'all are just overly producing. Let's find a hi-hat. And again, when you're producing, you don't have to get everything right. You know, as long as you get the main draft down, you can always go back and edit stuff, swap out a hi-hat, swap out a snare. I think Cassius Clay was the one who said how he makes like 10 beats in one day. He said he uses loops mainly. And when you use loops, it's like leveraging other people's talent. And you don't have to like spend a bunch of time making the melody, because once you make the melody, then you got to make the drums and you got to make the bass and everything else and the vocal idea most of the time. So if you want to shortcut that, you can leverage other people's melodies. I think Palace does that specifically. And there was another producer on Dylan's CO Morning Show that does it. Forgot his name though. I'll show you how to humanize this, give it a little swing, even though it's more trap drum based. Oh, here's a secret. You want to do it like a reverse, like a reverse clap. So you want to find something that has a decent trail off to it and then reverse it. So something like this could work. Let's try it. Hit reverse. Okay, so it goes into the beginning versus pew. So you need something with a pretty decent tail. Then what you could do is set a choke group. So let's go back to our pattern one and then look for the snare. And so you have to determine where you want it. So boom. So usually right here on the one and two. So put it on the ands and then look for your main snare. It doesn't really matter which one because I have multiple ones. Copy this cut group. So that's five. Go to your wrench tool and just change your cut group to five. So that when this reverses, it will cut off whenever it sees another cut, something in the cut group numbered five. So this clap isn't long enough. So what we can do, I'm trying to think, what other sound can we do? We need like a, but if we can't find a crash or like an open hi-hats are probably the best for this. Let me see if he has any in here. He might not. A lot of people don't make open hi-hat samples. Oh, open hi-hats, here we go. Okay, so this one is, we need a long open hi-hat. This could work, let's try this, drag it in. Okay, so it goes, and that's the secret to the bounce as well. Only thing is this has a tone to it. Let's see if we can find a tone that matches better. There we go. That works better. How do you switch to the sound so fast? I'm pressing the up button. Yep. They got vocals in here too. This is a cool low tag. Isn't this the... the Drake tag? I don't want to infringe on Drake's territory with, but that does sound pretty dope. So let's add that in just for flavor. I'll take it out later, but it does sound pretty dope. Let's add that in with like some delay. And let's do ping pong delay. It's a little off, I think, because there might be a gap. Wait. So what I'll do is I'll add it to the step just before, then go to your graph editor, go to shift, and then go to a time shift. There it is. So it sounds more on beat. Still sounds a little like delayed. Little boy. That's a little Asher boy, if y'all can see. He is a joy, I must say. King don't know how to handle him though. King's like trying to be. Look at King walking away. Oh my god.
Why you coming over here, man?
King doesn't know how to handle him.
What's up?
This is Sine.
Sine Walt.
Sine Monique. Excuse me. She said, what up? King is scared of a puppy, y'all.
Hey, puppy. I think it's a
party. King is really behind my keyboard, y'all. This is Asher. Asher Waller is his last name. Hold on. Let me turn the webcam. I gotta turn off the lock. Transform and. Okay, why are you scared of a little baby? Here he is. Okay. Asher Waller, dude. Look, his blue eyes are even more blue. He's on saturated mode. His mommy got a new tag. You got a new tag? Let me see that fresh chain, man. Boy, you fresh. Boy, you so fresh. He keeps him pretty fly. Oh, he got his rabies. There we go. This is Sine's puppy. He's doing wonderful. He's a great puppy mommy. She loves her. She loves him for real. I just like seeing people who enjoy, like, puppies are the best, I must say. Can't go wrong with a puppy. She's really good with them too. Like, when you train, here's a little tip for people who don't know much about dogs. Dogs are probably a godsend. I really think dogs are angels, to be honest with you guys. And I think they just show people how to be really fun. All right, my webcam's a little crooked. Hold up. King is really scared of this little puppy, y'all. King, he over here shaking. Get over here.
Get over here, you big.
Here's King. Let me put him on the big screen real quick. Because King was... Wait, come here. King doesn't have his collar on, so it's kind of hard to grip him sometimes. But King is really scared of that little tiny puppy. Come here. Stop. Hold on. King, come here.
Guppy!
Yeah, he's a big 5-year-old boy. My little boy, he needs a haircut. But other than a haircut, he's a pretty good boy. I took his chains off, so he's not fresh to death today, but he's a good boy. I must say, my life changed, though. When King came into my life, I became a lot more happy. So that's why I like seeing Sine with Asher, because I'm sure they're going to create a bond that you just can't get anywhere else. But she's amazing. So I'm gonna make this track. Excuse me. And we're gonna finish this thing. This might be a London on, whose tag is it? Is this London on the Tracks tag? Or is that like a producer named Six? Six, if you're watching the stream, sorry if I just stole your tag. I'm gonna take it out, but it sounds dope. Yeah, we're back on FL, so because I realized nobody was watching the Logic stuff, so I was like, all right, y'all must have been mad that I was putting up too many Logic videos. I was gonna do a mixing and mastering new video, but the thing was with the mixing and mastering, I planned on renting out this professional studio for like $1,300 a month or something like that. And it was a good idea when I had like other musicians involved, but now that this pandemic hit, it kind of you can't be around a lot of people, so that business plan might not be the best. Oh well, sorry, Natus. I know how important dogs are, so I mean, that's the day I don't want to see is when King has to transition to a different universe. But I don't know. I don't even want to think about it. One time I got so sad in bed when I realized that King one day would have to pass away. I got so sad in bed. It's like 3 years ago. Because dogs are really, I really think they're angels. For real.
Boy.
Okay. So let's figure out why this beat sounds a little less bouncy. I think it's that guitar. So here's like a nuance. In Ableton, you could do this a lot easier. But in FL, you have to kind of manually do it. So there's going to be little discrepancies. But if you go to gross beat, let's go to 1/4. And then let's right click, go to single curve. And let's make this like a choppier, like a Timbaland chop versus it just playing its own like rhythm. Because right now the rhythm of the guitar doesn't match the drums because it's too like, the guitar's too having its own rhythm. Everybody here poor, bro, we can't afford a MacBook. Yeah, I realize MacBooks are pretty expensive. I think the one I got was like $3,000, so I can understand it's not cheap. And I only did it really to test the Mac experience because some people bought Hermes on a Mac and they said they ran into some weird problems. So I had to make sure I could figure it out for them. And that's what we're dedicated to doing. So now the guitar has more of a like a up-down feel versus like a sideways feel. And this is the little subtlety that a lot of DJs use for their vocals and their synthesizers and stuff. Because this gives the track movement. Okay, so it gives you movement without having to go back and like redo the guitar and all this. So that's a little trick for, you know, your trap beats, I guess. Now the hi-hat's a little dry, so let's figure out a way to make it cooler. One way is go to your graph editor. Let's go to time shift and then turn this up. I use it almost like a velocity tool. So it goes up, down, up, down. And then this way, the timing is a little off per hi-hat. Because if you play real drums, you go like some hi-hats are a little bit early. They're not like super delayed. So you want to create that, but for trap. Now this one, you can't really hear. I didn't make these exaggerated, but let's see what this would sound like. And this is really good for boom bap Griselda type beats too. I want to do a Griselda one. See if we can find a Griselda sample in here somewhere. And shout out to all the sample makers out there who make dope melodies, because you guys are super talented. I'm talking about the people who make hit Command Option Z to go back. There we go. I forget the guy who's on. Anybody watch Dylan's Producer Grind CEO morning show today? Because there was a guy who came on the show and he played some of his loops and they sounded really good. I forget who that was though. I think it was It was something with Love Life. I think his name was lovelife.gb. Let me look this up because I'm probably half right, half wrong. Lovelife.gb Instagram. I think that's what he said it was. Yeah, it was him. And he has some dope melodies. So let me see if I can play one. Hopefully he doesn't get mad or anything. Big mistake you guys are making on your sales pages, include sound demos, okay? Because some people who just Google your name, they'll find the sales page and they won't know what YouTube video you made about it. So you got to make sure you include sounds on your actual sounds pages because we don't know what this sounds like. There's no reference. So that's a big mistake a lot of people make. And it will increase your sales. Like, I don't know how internet money got away with doing that for so long, but they could increase their sales just by putting some demo tracks right on that page. It's making me log in. Let me see if I can find a loop. Where did he play the loop from? Oh, he must have emailed him. I think that's what he did. Whatever. I tried to put him on, but he has some. Let's see if we can find his like YouTube or something. I think it was produced by, I guess his promo worked because he only shouted his name out once and Dylan was like, oh, you just promoting, huh? But it worked because I'm looking up his stuff right now. produced by Love Life YouTube. All right, let's see. I think this is his YouTube. I don't know though. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like it. Hold on, y'all. I'm trying to figure out. Is this his thing? Produced by Love Life. Produced Love Life. If you're in the chat, that'd be extra dope too if he was actually here. I'll know by the melody. If it doesn't sound like what I know, then whatever. They just sound really like movies almost. I think he uses a lot of film score stuff. I don't know. But he has like a lot of flutes, a lot of like the vocal, the you like that film score vocal? Dark mode just makes me depressed. I don't use dark mode on my phone. I think people use dark mode. Whatever, I'm not going to put my opinions out there. Never mind. Does two-core CPU computers enough to run Hermes? Two-core CPU computers? It shouldn't be draining on your CPU. Hermes should not be draining. My developer gave me the specs. I don't know if I put them on the website or not. Let's see. Hold up. Hold up. Let's go to www.hermesplugin.com. And then if you click Get Hermes Now, it should tell you the specs. Oh, I didn't put them there. I'm salty. Oh, you know what? I think I put them down here. Dang, I really didn't put the specs on the page. You just reminded me I needed to add the specs. So I'm feeling extra salty. Add specs to page Hermes. My developer gave me the specs one day. But yes, it should be able to run on your basic computers. It's not a CPU hog. It's not doing anything crazy behind the scenes. It just plays sounds. It doesn't like extract from your, it's not like AI technology and all that. Do you know YZ Beats? He samples, but I don't know why people are mad at him, because it was obvious. What happened? What do you mean? Producers were mad? What do you mean? I feel like the beat's done. It's got to. See how it has that kind of push-pull feel now with the hi-hats versus just tick, 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 tick. Also, I noticed in a CEO morning show with Dylan from Producer Grind this morning, he played somebody who won the beat battle. I forget their name. Shout out to J Myth was in that beat battle. But whoever won the beat battle, his drums sounded really good, but they sounded very like linear. It didn't have like a swing to it. And so what I'm trying to show you is how to take your drums to that next level. If you go to the graph editor, go to time shift, and then use this as a way to add a little more human timing. This will literally transform your drums forever. It's how you add that bounce back to your drums without it sounding offbeat and, you know, not quantized and stuff. Yeah, 808s will do that in a sec. Just saying, Hermes is super dope, straight to what it needs. Awesome, Ice Mike, thank you for that. Yeah, I just want to make sure before I push it heavier that we get any bugs out of the way. And apparently somebody on Mac said they get like a black screen or something, so I have to check out why. It could be a Mac security issue, which it probably is. Macs ask you if you want to do everything. They're like, you sure you want to load that hi-hat? Are you positive? They're like, are you sure you want to load this kick? We're going to access the documents. It's like stuff that PC you just do naturally. Where would mud most likely be in pianos? Around 200 hertz up to 400 hertz. That's the muddy. That's where all the fundamental frequencies tend to stack. So 200 hertz to 400 hertz. Check there. So I learned a trick from Joe Budden podcast. I forget what the song was. It was, I don't remember. I think it was, was it D'Angelo? And the beat had a change up in the kick every bar. Every bar, for four bars, the kick had a change up. So for R&B, a quick way to kind of make this work is make a change in your kick every bar. Now keep in mind we're in double time, so every two bars in double time. Make a change in your kick. So let's go to pattern three. And a simple change you can make is like a double kick, like boom, boom. Okay, so let's kind of keep that bounce. And pattern four. I know I'm moving a little bit quicker here because I'm just trying to show you how to make beats faster. we're gonna add a boom, 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 a Brandy type beat. These beats are gonna be for a Sine Monique and Busyworks Beats joint album. It's gonna be called No One Like Me. And these guitar loops were made specifically for this album, so that's why I'm using these guitar loops. And he contributed to the power pack as well, for free, for you guys. His name is 7 Foot G. He's super dope with the guitar. Check him out on Instagram too. Crazy with the guitar. So you see how the kick goes beyond the actual envelope? This is part of the reason why it sounds hard. So if you want your kick like that, you would go to pre-computed effects and turn up your boost. Okay, so most of your drums that you have just aren't turned up high enough. And you try to make an R&B mix with drill? That's two different genres. That's kind of like hardcore gospel. That's not gonna not gonna blend. You know those memes that have like people fighting and it's like, or like gospel music when people are fighting on Worldstar? It's called music mismatch. And those are two genres that don't go together. Drill beats and R&B beats. I don't think drill and B will ever be a genre, in my opinion. Because drill's whole storyline is based off of violence and street stuff, and R&B is based off of like sweeter sounds. So I wouldn't combine those two. It's not going to be a good blend. It's like adding chocolate and what's something that doesn't taste good with chocolate? Like chocolate and like a pear or something like that. Something that chocolate wouldn't taste good with. Okay, so we need an 808. Let's see if I can find an 808 in here. So these 808s, I don't know when he made the Wave Kit 1, but these 808s are from a different generation, I'm assuming. So they're not your like plug 808 with that short sound to it. So let me see if I can find one that sounds... Let me skip up to actually kit number 5, because these probably have more like Migos style 808s. Here we go. Also, you want to find an 808 that rumbles, right? This one kind of is low frequency. And we would need a couple more tools to make this stand out. It's super clean, though. Actually, here's what I'll do. I'll run it through one of my favorite plugins and see if it matches. So with the 808, let's play the 808 just by itself. And then here's a trick. Hit Control, left-click, and highlight everything. Hit Control, Command or Control G. That's going to group it. Hit Shift, left-click, duplicate it over. And then hit the top button, gonna make unique. So now it's two different like grouped sections. And for pattern 3, we're gonna go inside the pattern and hit Control X or Command X to get rid of all the kicks. And then we're gonna have the 808 play without the kick. So hopefully I'm making sense. Does the guitar loop pack you're using is free? I think 7 Foot G gave you guys one called RF Pack 1 and RF Pack 2. Those are royalty free to use. Yep, you don't have to worry about clearing anything or anything like that. So he recorded those. The other two are for Sine Monique and myself for the album. So those aren't for public. Those are our specific ones. So this 808 is a little, it doesn't have a lot of impact. So this is a case of, okay, if we take out the kick, will the 808 have enough impact to actually replace a kick? That's why I said it's dependent on the type of 808. Some 808s actually have kicks inside the 808. You just don't know because of the leveling. But some 808s are actually kicks plus 808s. If you add a little saxophone in the beat, how can someone join the list of sample packs? You're talking about for the producer community? Well, we have a producer community folder right now. I'm working on it. I have a bunch of entertainment attorneys drafting up a bunch of stuff right now. So what it's going to look like is this, basically. You're going to come to a website and agree to the terms and conditions, which basically say, hey, if you want to download these royalty-free loops, you're free to download the royalty-free loops. All we ask is that you credit the people who made the loops for you. And for the people who want to contribute to the loop folder, it says that you acknowledge that you're actually giving it away for royalty free and you're actually going to let people make money with it without expecting anything on the back end, so that it protects both people. It protects the people that want to use the loops and it protects the people who are giving the loops because they, you know, they need credit. So it's going to be a simple thing where you go to a website, probably like busyworksbeats.com/community or something like that. I'll make a link for it. And then you just read the terms, and then you'll be able to sign the thing at the bottom via like your finger or DocuSign. I'm trying to get DocuSign to work, but it's like a glitch right now. So I got to figure out why it's glitching. But if you, anyway, you just type in your name, your email, and it'll like create like a little auto signature for you, which just acknowledges that you read those terms. Okay. Cause it's with music, you just got to be careful that people understand what the terms are, because a lot of people, they try to do shady stuff, but we're trying to make a computer, a community folder where there cannot be shady stuff going on. So I had brought in a lot of, entertainment lawyer counsel to figure out how to draft those contracts to be correct. So that's why I kind of paused on that producer community loop folder. Long story short, yes, you can grab all those free loops within the community folder. What do you think about MIDI Friend? Oh, I love MIDI Friend. That's my friend Evan. I'm not sure if he's even like publicly in the public about that, but anyway, MIDI Friend, I know the owner, and he's a really good guy, and those MIDIs are really good. I have to re-download the MIDI folder, because I tried to download my friend's folder earlier, but it stopped downloading, so I had to re-download it. But I do like MIDI Friend. Very dope. Let me actually go there, because I ran through some sounds. I'm glad you said that, because I'm like getting back into loving sounds again, like finding new sounds. So MIDIFriend.com, build your MIDI library. Oh yeah, he has a video about it. So this is Evan. He owns Studio Link. So if you guys are familiar.
Hi, and how's it going, music producers?
So Evan's really dope as a person. He's really, really dope. And I must say, shout out to Evan. And what was I gonna say about Evan? So he helped me with the first plugin we made called Vintage Fire. He actually helped develop the back end part of that plugin. I delivered him the sounds. He put together the technology, and then Vintage Fire was made. It came out really good as a product. And I just wanted to add more features and kind of do my own thing, because he was working on his own projects. So I didn't want to like bog him down with my requests. So I had to find a private developer team, and we did a partnership and all this type of stuff. So he helped me kind of get into the plugin world. And it's just super fun to be able to bring you guys like super dope sounds. Anyway, so he has a new website called MIDIFriend.com. And on MIDIFriend is basically Netflix for MIDI. So you go on MIDIFriend.com, shout out to Evan. Let me go to his website real quick. And let's go here. And what you can do is, the reason I like MIDIFriend is because it's all MIDI, which allows you to change out the sound. So let's say you're a loop pack maker and you just want like quick ideas that you can flip and make your own. Of course, you can't just drag the MIDI and just, actually you could technically, because it's MIDI. Drag the Eldre has a MIDI thing in here. I didn't even know that. Shout out to Eldre. But you see, we're all working together. Like, these are my friends. We work together. We want to see each other succeed. So of course I'm going to plug MIDIFriend.com. I want to see him win, because it just makes us all look better, because it's owned by a producer who actually cares about the community. Anyway, you go to the genre you want, and let's say you make loop packs. You could just drag the MIDI, swap out the sound for like a trumpet, and then there you go, and add some effects to it. How do I get the loops? Sorry, I joined in late. The loops for, I'm gonna have to put a new link. Where did I put those loops at? I don't even remember. I think they're in the power pack, but the power pack, I have to log into a bunch of stuff. Hopefully if I remember, I'm gonna add that link. So power pack, I'll add that to the link for the replay. I just can't do it now because I have to log into Google Sheets and it has sensitive information, because I have a bunch of data from my business in there. So the power pack, add to description. I'll do that later. But that's where you can get all these loops. Actually, I'm gonna email everybody. I'll just email everybody so that you can get it. I haven't emailed you guys in a minute. So I know I'm taking forever to explain this, but on MIDIFriend, you can search via key. So they have cinematic key, Latin. I mean, he really went in with this, and he got real players to do this stuff. So it's not just like hacked jobs. So like Bryson Tiller Beats, if you wanted to do a Bryson Tiller thing. Wait, did I? Oh, wait, I think I clicked on the wrong thing. Hold up. Wait, artist tag. Oh, let me refresh. I think I clicked on something wrong. Let me see. But it basically pulls up the MIDI for it. It looks like he has MIDI for drums too in here. Did I see that right? He even has MIDI for drums, which is pretty dope. We need like some BusyWorks Beats type MIDIs up in here. So, wait, I don't know if I'm doing this right. browse. Maybe if I type in Bryson Tiller. Let me see. Bryson Tiller. Oh, here's one. Okay, so it's called Legendary. The giveaway's tomorrow. We're going to do the giveaway. Just go to the link busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio to enter the giveaway. I did this video so you have a chance to enter. The best dogs are cats. That's funny. Yeah, hilarious. So anyway, go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. We're going to do the giveaway live tomorrow at 9 p.m. Eastern time. Why is it that I can't buy only one course from your Music Theory Essentials? That's something that I need to make. It's really me and my development. I need to find somebody who can code websites. That's really what it comes down to. Kairu. Because we used to sell them individually, like Melody Magic, Music Theory in a Day, and Chord Magic. So if you had a specific interest. So we're gonna redo that. I just have to redo the sales pages, they're called, so that you can order it properly. Once I make it in the industry, I'm shouting you out. There we go. Thanks, Rashan. Rasan. How can I make a beat more complex? Sometimes you don't need to. Complexity can actually hurt you. So here's the MIDI. Just super dope. And then you would download the MIDI, drag it into FL, and just, you know, throw it on whatever instrument you want. So I've done it before. I need to re-download that because I'm on my Mac now. So I need to re-download that. And we'll dig into MIDI, friend, because I like the business idea and I like the actual use of the idea. Let's find an 808 that matches. Then we'll wrap this one up and then move to the next beat. Here's a more, nah, that might be too trappy, this one. Well, this is kind of like R&B-esque, very long pause, I guess. So we got, dun, wait, dun, dun, dun. So, boom, boom, boom. It might be out of key a little bit. Let me turn this down just a little bit. I know my brain's all over the place, so give me a second to like speak my alien language. Okay, so let's pull it down an octave, control down. Oh, that's too dark. Or maybe. Yeah, it probably needs like an electronic bass. I don't have Trillion on this machine though, that's the thing. I didn't realize how much I use those other plugins. Jimbo says, love your classes. Thank you for the testimonial. What's up, Nicholas or Nicholas? What's up? Yes. Also, I want to work on bringing you more material. I want to do a lot of stuff, but I learned my lesson 2019. I was trying to do too much stuff and it's not a good idea to do more than one thing at a time. It's a very bad idea. Two things at the max, like one thing to constantly work on, another thing to work on. If it's gonna take a while, two things max. Don't overly work yourself, because then you're gonna drop a lot of ideas. And I'm not, this 808 might not work. I like the bass line, but the sound doesn't work. I'm thinking, where could I grab bass from? I don't have Omnistron here either. Where are you? Find high quality R&B acapella. What's it called? DJ Pool? Look for DJ Pools. I think they're called DJ Pools. Largest online DJ pool. I think they give you acapellas or... Wait, I might be wrong. Hold up. Unlimited downloads. Let's see what this is. The world's best record pool and DJ network. Let me just search acapella. Oh yeah, here we go. Find every version you need. Intros clean, acapellas, dirty remixes, and get song. So this is where you would find them. So join a DJ pool. Let's see how much it costs. It costs you $20 a month. And then I guess you could try it out, just cancel if you want. So that's where Trizza. If you want more DJ information, hit up at Trizza on, hit him up for a consultation, because he comes from that world. He was DJing since he was like young, he said. So, the 808's not what I want. I never really picked from the Big White Beats 808s anyway. I picked from the Scott Storch ones, and I don't have his Scott Storch ones on here. Let's see if I can find a different 808. Busy Works Heat. How did I not see this? I'm going to send him a picture. Jacob is funny, man. I did not even see this till now. He names certain sounds after people. And I just didn't even notice that. But shout out to him. I'm choking on like air or something. But my best friend Jacob's a really dope sound designer. Very dope. And I want to introduce him to you guys even more. I think we only chatted on the live stream once, but we definitely got to get him on because he understands. Okay, so I'm talking too much. So let's, is this the same 808? This one has like a little extra vibration. Wait, now, let me turn this up a little bit so I can hear. I kind of like the high pitch. Dum, boom. So here's what I'll do. I'm going to leave it high pitched, almost like that Drake record where he's rapping over the Jay-Z sample. I'm just going to change the notes. So boom, boom, wait, boom, boom. Or actually, let's do that. Wait, is it octave or fifth? No, let's not do the octave. Wait, boom. There we go. I know I'm speaking to myself almost like a weird man, but this is how I produce. I just kind of like move my mouth and talk to myself. Pause, I guess. Gotta say pause just in case. Yeah, Evan is from Producer Grind. He's a very nice guy. Dun, dun, dun. So, dun. Boom. There we go. Oh, time these wrong. Let's do that. Sometimes you gotta be careful though with the bass because you could be doing way too much. Keyboard behind me. Oh yeah, it's not plugged up though. I don't have my MIDI outs plugged up. I do have a keyboard right here, you're right. Duh. Shout out to Sleepy for the being my second brain. No, it's definitely not a COVID cough. It's from, it's so hot in this room. I'm trying to make excuses. Like it's so hot in here. Trust me, y'all. It's hot in here. It's hot. It's not even that hot in here. You know what it is? It's dry air from the studio. Plus, I'm allergic to dust. Plus, I've been using my voice all week, so like sometimes my voice gets a little rattly. Plus, what else could it cause the cough? Plus, dog hair sometimes makes me choke up a little bit. So when King came in here, he hasn't had a bath in a long time. And he could be carrying allergens on his fur. Wait, dang. Boom, boom. Then we'll be done. So, I mean, the beat's basic. It really comes down to your vocal. I think people overly produce nowadays. Do way too much. Especially on R&B. Boom. Boom, boom. Let's get that. I'm not sure I like the boom boom. I might change the timing to boom boom. Shout out to Jacob's 808 for saving the day. Then you would like try to do vocals. Let's see if I can find the key. I know I'm kind of talking all over the place. Y'all probably like, yo, can you have one singular thought? No, I can't. I cannot. It's my inner Aries coming out. I have, natural attention. No, I can pay attention. Let me stop saying that. Juno bass would probably work, but I don't have any plugins that has that. The bass is a sample from, it's called 808 Bajan Wants Smoke from Octave. Octave comes with also a drum kit. So this comes with Octave. So I got it from Jacob, my best friend Jacob. Did Kenny Beat send you that loop with the guitar loop? No, this is from 7 Foot G. So he's a really dope player on Instagram. You could look him up at 7 Foot G. Crazy player up in New York. Just super talented. And I would highly recommend you get your own custom pack from him. Oh, let me find the key so I could hack my way through this. Okay, so we found the key. Let me just make... Let's grab autotune. Also, I've been eating more dairy. I need to stop eating like cookies and stuff because I walk a lot of steps. Like today I walked 7,000 steps before the date. Like it's, I still have another big walk I have to do. So I'm doing a lot of steps, but then I'll like come back in and eat like a cookie or something stupid. Now I'll just waste all the time I just walked. So dairy can throw you off your sinuses too. So here are the notes. And so right now it's, we have C. Also autotune, this new one has key detection, but I don't know how it works. So let's remove the notes that we're not gonna use. Let's remove C sharp, let's remove E. Let's remove F sharp. Let's remove G sharp. And remove B. So here's our key. Now I'm gonna hack my way through a melody. They should have never introduced me to autotune. Autotune is like my favorite plugin. Shout out to Entourage. I met them at the Splice party out in LA, out in NAMM. They're pretty fun. I like guitar so much. So now when I hum and kind of mumble, it will make sound better. I need to install my Waves plugins so I can get that doubler going. But you hear that, like, here, let me turn this thing. Can you, well, no, you can't hear. Hold up. My Mac is just making so much noise. I want you guys to hear how much noise this thing's making. You hear my computer? And I'm only sitting about 1 foot away from the computer. That noise is very loud, so. Only thing you, so technically I'm supposed to use that mic over there, but it's not plugged up, I don't think. It might be plugged up, I just don't feel like turning it on. So this is a reference vocal, it's not gonna be the absolute vocal. So letting y'all know. So don't judge me. It's like, nah, it doesn't matter if you do or not. You can say I suck, I don't care. Autotune makes me feel like I can sing. Let me breathe, you know what I mean? Let me breathe, man. Let me breathe, man. All right. Let's record. And then when you do this practice of adding your own vocals, it will show you where your beat needs to change. Like you'll see where you start to actually, where the beat gets in the way. Like your kicks might be messed up or something like that. So this is an exercise I recommend all producers do, whether you can sing or not. It just shows you like where your gaps need to be better. I walked 7,000 and started choking on the air. My max... John got jokes, man. That's funny. I don't even know why that's funny. It's just funny that you quoted it. It was whatever. Thank you. But that was, thank you for the laugh. Wait, no, I'm not going to. Oh my gosh, now I'm not gonna have a serious face while I'm recording. Oh man. Okay, let's record this hack. Oh man, let's record this. Yo, did you see Kyle Beats? Every video he puts out is insane. And I think he heard me say it because his latest video is, this is insane. So shout out to Kyle Beats for always branding his beat, his videos as insane. I'm like, every time I see his video title, it says something about insanity. Like his last video, this is insane, or he switches it up. Maybe I was going too hard on him. I thought every maybe not. Okay, well, he used to do it. Now it looks like he changes it up a lot more, but it used to be his thing. But everything's like, this is insane. Shout out to Kyle Beats. Okay, let's record. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back and add like a background track, but harmonize it so that it doesn't. So, okay, I know I'm doing 8 tasks at once. We need to right click, file, save mixer track state as, and then drag it over to like a blank track, track 20. Let's send this vocal to that track specifically. In the PC version, you could left click and type, but on Mac, you can't type it in. So I have to manually do this. So let's do 20, so it doesn't sound out of key. And then I'm going to record a harmony, which is going to sing a different note, or you could do the same note but just a backtrack. The mumble boss. Yeah, I've seen like a really high level songwriter, he mumbles and just sometimes comes up with the words. Oh wait, if you don't want to say, I will. Oh wait, I'm your vocal conscious. Oh, low cuts, what, you read my mind? Oh, wait. Am I missing something? Wait, John's word. Hey, I'm missing something. Nah, I was just laughing at John. It was funny. Hilarious. What do you think about the sauce? I didn't use the sauce plugin by Kyle Beats, but I know a friend who made the sauce plugin, and his version is like a different plugin. So, I don't know. I think Kyle Beats changed the name of the sauce. Because my other friend owned the trademark to the sauce for a plugin name. So you can't have the same name when it comes to products. So I think Kyle Beats might have changed his thing. If not, I don't know how. I didn't use the Kyle Beats plugin yet. Let's put it that way. No shade towards Kyle Beats. We had an interview episode. Okay, so let's record again. Sounds like it's not even going through auto-tune. Let me make sure that went through auto-tune. I didn't realize I sounded so out of key. Let me make sure this thing is in key first. Dag, it sounded super out of key. You know when you hear yourself like without auto-tune, you're like, dag, that's what I sound like? Why it sounds delayed too, that's another thing. Let me see, there's no latency button on here, so not that I see. I don't know why this sounds delayed. We would have to like readjust it. See how it sounds like delayed a little bit? Let me fix that because that's going to throw me off when I'm recording this one. So let's take it off time stretch mode. Sorry, I'm missing comments right now. What mic? This is a Shure SM7B. I don't really use it to record though. It's only for video. But this is the mic that Michael Jackson used to use. So it's known for its name. But I mean, it's a good mic for the price. Let's put it that way. And it sounds good. I know Palace, but it's more like for deeper voices in my opinion. That could be wrong. I mean, it depends on your voice. I know Palace used a lot of UA plugins on his master before, but now he only uses Soft Clipper. I wonder, is it better? Depends if you're making beats or what you're trying to do. Here's the thing. People make mastering way too overly dark. It's not that. It really comes down to EQ, stereo imaging, and a compressor and a limiter. That's really all it is. Everything else is just extra. So let's hit Alt and drag it to the left. Make sure this lines up. So now I'm gonna try and add that vocal flare. Was kind of whack. Let me do it again. Oh, also when you're recording, put this on pre so that when you record it doesn't hard boil all these effects so that you can always go back and change it. That's something that Sicky Beats taught me, so shout out to Sicky Beats. He's actually in the mastermind group now, so shout out to him. It's funny because I think earlier in his career, he like had harsh words for me, but you know what? I let it go. I think it was him. It had to be him because I remember he was like, Busy Works Beats doesn't even know what he's talking about or something. I forget what it was, but it's all good. I'd rather somebody disagree with me than just not care. How to make melodies easy for beginners? That's a big question. Let me just finish this vocal reference real quick. I wish I could sing. I might start on a high pitch. Thing I realized that my mic is set up to, it's like if I back up too far, check, you can't hear me. So I was trying to do very soft stuff, but the mic cut it out. So it's a little crazy stuff while you record. Let's send this to track 20 and let's copy this and paste. So let's right click, hit P to paste. Let's see what this sounds like combined. Oh, also, it's probably a bad idea to use one auto-tune for two vocals. So what I'm going to do is save this mixer track state as... drag it over to 21 and then... slide this over to 21. So in the beginning, I was trying to fill out the harmony. I'm was cutting off my words. So some things, again, I'm going to go back and record on the other microphone. But at least I know what the idea I was going for is. That's how you make beats a little bit faster, even though we went on like 18 tangents. That's how you make beats kind of faster. So let's pick a different loop for the next beat. How long have we been live streaming? I have a little more energy in me today than usual. Only an hour? Oh, an hour and a half. Okay, well, that's with a bunch of tangents too. Let me see what you're saying. You said I thought it was the Vinyl FX plugin first. What, the pitch wobble? I don't know what you're referring to. RC20 is a multi-effect plugin. Oh, you're asking. Oh, I see what you mean. You're saying you thought it was only the Vinyl FX? Reverb. Oh, I thought you said something else. Reverb. Interesting. You use it for reverb. What is this? What does Kyle Beats plugin actually do? I can try and Google it, but I saw him release the plugin and I congratulated him like the moment I saw the plugin. What does it do? It looks like it. Let's go to Kyle Beats. Where's the website? Oh, it's called Secret Sauce. Okay, it's called Secret Sauce instead of The Sauce. Oh, wait, that's not it. That is not it. Okay, where's it at? All right, how do you find this thing? Let's go to kylebeats.com and scroll around. I might have to text this man and be like, yo, where's your plugin? Where is it at? Does somebody know where his plugin is? Let me click the link in his YouTube thing. Hold up. Okay. Oh, thesauceplugin.com. Wait, it's called Your Secret Sauce. Okay. Your Secret Sauce. Oh, wait, what? Get notified for our next launch. Wait, is it not for sale? No way. It's not for sale? Are you joking? What? Wait, I'm a little confused. Shout out to Jacob. Yeah, Jacob's super dope. Shout out to him. Wondering, I didn't know his plugin. I think it will be back soon. Oh, he's fixing bugs. Okay. Okay, so yeah, I didn't get a chance to use it yet. For the person who asked me initially if I liked it, I just didn't get a chance to use it yet. But I always support people who are producers who are actually making products for producers instead of these big companies. It's like, why don't we make our own stuff? And Kyle Beats went down that path, made his own stuff. Superstar O made his own stuff. Modern producers made their own stuff. Who else is, you know, Sound Oracle? The list goes on and on and on and on and on. So shout out to everybody who does that. Okay, next beat, we're going to add some loops up in this thing. If you're new or like you didn't hear, go to busyworksbeats.com to enter the... I mean, not busyworksbeats.com. Hold on. Go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio to enter the FL Studio giveaway. And all you got to do is just sign up. It's so that we know how to pick a winner, because we have to have people sign up so that we can go to the number generator and then pick a number, and then that number ties to a person's name. Okay. Also, I was going to say, you get free samples just for joining. So you win regardless. I just wanted to give you something so that you know that we care over here. Hold up. Let's save this. And let's go to a new project. All right. All right. So I sound different. Oh, no, I don't. It's the reverb. The Genesis Pro. I haven't downloaded that. Kyle Beats had to take it down because of the name. Oh, sorry to hear that. I do know the owner of The Sauce, which is DJ Swivel. And so I want Kyle Beats to know if he's watching this replay. Like, I wasn't behind the reason why that happened. It's just, it was already owned by somebody else. So that's what it came down to. But anyway, DJ Swivel made a dope plugin called The Sauce. And it's super dope. But I support both the guys. I'm not saying there's a beef or anything. I just support both of them. So the sauce is basically, it has a really dope Format filter in it for like EDM folks or people who want that pop sound. For the Format filter, it creates like this sound, that kind of sound. And you can, it has compression built in, chorus, flanger, what is spice? Saturation and distortion. It has a reverb in it, delay. It's like every vocal thing you would use all in one. So that's the sauce plugin. And you can find it at Sweetwater, wherever, on his website. Looks like Plugin Boutique has it for a little bit cheaper if you want to get it there. Shout out to Swivel. He got it into like every store possible. but I know all these developers, that's why, and the owners of all this stuff. So that's why it's kind of cool. Bought Genesis Pro for $1. Yeah, I heard that guy was working on that thing for like 11 years or something. What's the story behind Genesis Pro? And that was his way of contributing. I like people who contribute to the community who also have products, not just these big companies who just milk the community over and over and over again. So here are loops from the royalty-free guitars that we sent out to you guys. Let's make something with this. Actually, I want to I want like a track loop. Let me see. Beat Sculptor added some samples to the power pack. That's free VST. DAW, the ones that come with your stock DAW are the best ones. Like Logic Pro's plugins are probably the best next to Studio One's. Shout out to Beat Sculptor. Keyscape Library. Well, you gotta kind of buy it. This is dope. Let's use this. Let's go to song mode. So let's count the beats, the bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2, 2, 3. Usually on their website on spectrasonics.net, they have a thing where you can like check if you have the right stuff. So like if you go to spectrasonics.net, you log in to the login right here, and then it'll show you like a members area, and then you'll have this thing that checks if you have the right version of the plugin, and it shows like a green or a red light. You'll know when you log in. So log in here and then you'll see your products that you bought, and then that's how you authorize it. You do it through the website. Shout out to Eric Persing at Spectrasonics. Super dope company. And I just want to learn how to sound design to like a high level. I want a mentor to just be like, you know, here, I'm going to bring in the coolest people, dopest sounds. Okay, anyway, go to song 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, and 1. Why is it 14 bars? That sounds right though. Like it's 14 bars, but it sounds right. Let's leave it at 14 bars. Even though it says 160. Let's see what it 160. Oh, 16 bar. Why? It just sounded right, though. It didn't sound like it was... Oh, really? My counting was off? I'm stupid, then. I'm just dumb. That's hilarious. If my counting was off, that makes that even funnier. Let's say trap kind of... What is it called? Trap soul? Shout out to Bryson Tiller for making this a whole genre. Oh, that's why. Wow, I can't. I'm slow. When's the FL Studio giveaway? Tomorrow. We're going to pick the winner tomorrow, but you can enter for free now. Get a bunch of free sounds. Tonight, check your emails because I'm going to send out the power pack again, which has a bunch of free sounds for you guys so that you don't have to use a bunch of crappy stock sounds. You can actually use sounds from people who make dope stuff. And I'll give that to you for free just for being cool. Okay. And then I'll send everybody who helped with the survey a different pack that has sounds that haven't been released. So that's, I'll do that tonight. Let me record this melody before I forget.
No,
I forgot to turn off loop mode, so I screwed up the ending because it's technically not supposed to cut off, but whatever. It'll have a little click. A little click, most likely. I was going after that like Sampha sound, or the guy who worked with Drake. I forget his name. Who's that guy that did the song with Drake? Chicago West or something like that? Or whatever his name is. That sounds so wrong if I just say whatever his name is. It's something. Dang, what's the guy's name? Who's the guy that sounds like Sampha, but it's not Sampha? That worked with Drake. Drake. It's like a top titled track. What is it called? Chicago Freestyle. That's what it's called. Chicago Freestyle featuring Giveon. Okay, that's his name. Giveon or Giveon. He's like the new Sampha sound, I guess, for Drake. Wonder what happened to Sampha and Drake. What the heck? Come on. But that UK, they go personal, personal, personal. They have like this weird act. Not weird, but it sounds good. I did it more in the second take, but that's that UK personal, personal, personal. That's how they say personal. Sorry for you UK people out there. Personal. Let's copy this. But I do like the UK accent to a degree. But there was somebody on Dylan's show, the Producer Grind morning show. He was like, "Thank you, mate. Thank you." And I was like, "Thank you." Then I was like, "How do they say thought? Like T-H-O-U-G-H-T. I thought you were talking about someone else. I thought. It's like, how do you say thought? Like F-O-U-G-H-T. And then how do you separate that from saying T-H-O-U-G-H-T? That went through my mind earlier. And that was that producer. I think his name was Love Life. Yeah, Love Life. Yeah, that was his name. Love Life. Prince Harry. Who's that? Is that the guy that... The Meghan Markle girl? What's your thoughts on the plugin Iris 2? I haven't used that. I don't know what that is. I haven't used it. I don't even know what it does. Is there an easy way to mix different multi-tracks together? Yes. Just separate them frequency-wise. So just start asking the question, okay, what frequency range does this melody take up? Mostly like the high mids. Then it has like a boom, like a bass. So it takes up those two ranges. So you want to find sounds that take up the other stuff so that you don't have to even mix it very well. You just separate it frequency-wise. So if my bass frequency is taken care of and my high mids, that means I need a low mid sound and I need a high sound. And then you would map out your beat that way. Start separating the sounds by like the sound source itself. What up, Kevin? Well, you only missed, you know, very important information. No, you missed. We made an R&B track out of a guitar. So I'm just warming up to my R&B stuff. I'm trying to make tracks for this joint album. So it's going to take a lot of production. How do you know the frequency? Just separate sound into really high frequencies, like tss, that's a high frequency. High mids would be like, hey guys, that's high mid. Low mid would be like, hey guys. It's not bassy, but it's not bass. And then it's like, hey guys. You know, it's four different, think about four different people talking. You have a baby talking, hey guys, you know, hey guys. And then you have the high mids, hey guys. Then you have the low mid, hey guys. And then you have the bass talker who's like, hey guys. Hey guys, how you doing? So that's, just think of it that way. And then you'll start picking sounds better. What's the best EQ that you work with? It's called FabFilter Pro Q3, but it's kind of expensive. But it's well worth it. How do you know? Let me turn my vocal back on.
You know.
See, this, I'm getting into too much technical jargon, I mean. So let's just EQ out the boomy frequency. So one trick you can do instead of EQing out all the bass from your vocal, you can widen out the bass so that it doesn't clash with the bass in the center. I know I'm gonna confuse a lot of you guys, but bass comes in two directions. It comes dead on, which is called mono bass, which is straight up and down the middle of your headphones, and then you have bass that's on the sides. So the way you can do it is let some bass live on the sides, like for your vocal, and then have the bass guitar sound, or the bass sound, whatever, is the bass, be in the middle so they don't clash. The only thing is I didn't install my Isotope plugin that I would usually use for this. So I'm trying to think of an equivalent plugin that I could use. What could I use to separate sounds? What could I use? I don't think I have the plugin I want. But that would be the way to solve that issue. Sometimes, I know I'm getting into too much mixing. Mixing is such a deep science. Sometimes, though, you want to let it feel more like not super polished. You want to feel like how Drake did the Givian sample, or how Drake did the Sampha sample, where it felt like you were in the room with that person. It didn't feel like some overly cleaned up sound. So sometimes you want to let the bass come through just to feel like they're actually in the moment. Guys like Tyler, the Creator, got that sub low frequency on their vocals. Yeah, a lot of guys, I think Ken Lewis taught this in his, here's a dope website if you guys want to learn mixing. This is where I learned it. Audio School Online. His name is Ken Lewis, and I would recommend just buying the Everything Bundle if he has it still. Let me see if he has it still. You can build your own bundle. He used to have an Everything Bundle where it had everything all in one. I might just buy it again just to support his stuff and kind of re-go through his stuff too. So here's, if you want to learn mixing, you can learn from me, which is showing you how to use it in FL, how to mix inside an actual room in your house. So I'm showing you the in the trenches kind of mixing. Ken Lewis has his own home setup, but it's, I think he's in a treated environment and he's like Grammy winning. I think he'll teach you the philosophies behind mixing. Then you have Sound Oracle has a, whoops, not Refersion. Sound Oracle has something on his thing. Let me see. Sound Oracle has, where's it at? His mixing course called The Art of Beat Mixing. I bought this course. I still have to go through all of it. But Realistic Productions teaches this, and he's a super genius about mixing as well. And he has a professional setup too, but it's in a home environment. So the only difference I would say from their perspective is that they have the rooms treated and they have like all the acoustic treatment, whereas you don't necessarily have that. So sometimes they'll teach you stuff, but you have to remember that their perspective is completely different than yours. So just keep that in mind. He's going to teach you solid principles, but keep in mind, like, don't memorize where exactly he EQ'd all the time. Because in your room, you could be, it might be a different spot. So I used to, when I was learning mixing, I used to copy the exact like frequency people were EQing out. And you got to remember that everybody's room is different. So I would recommend those two. Audio School Online is where I learned from Ken Lewis, and then Realistic Productions has his own mixing course that I bought as well. So you need to, I'm going to rebuy like all his, okay, the Everything Bundle is only $330. That's nothing. This is like college level mixing training. But the thing is, here's another thing about mixing, and I'll keep my little dissertation short. Ken Lewis teaches on Pro Tools. I think Realistic teaches on Pro Tools as well. And that's another thing about these mixing courses. But the good thing is you can apply what they're doing to FL Studio, because I learned from Ken Lewis. He taught on Pro Tools and he had a bunch of plugins that I didn't have, but I still applied it to the plugins that I could understand. So they can't sing. Yeah, I'll give you all my mixing multi-tracks for free to mix. I need to update the mixing course. There's so much crap I need to update with BusyWorks Beats. It's just, I got to do one thing at a time or else it could get overwhelming. So I just got to do one thing at a time. Right now, we're just trying to fix Hermes. Just check, troubleshoot Hermes, make sure Hermes is good. And we'll do the next thing. Okay. How to use Neve. Yeah, Neve EQ or preamp, excuse me, 1073. Yeah, I could use the stereo enhancer, but it doesn't do frequency-based stuff. So what I'll do tonight, I'm going to buy Ken Lewis's Everything Bundle. He's dope. Also, Bob Osinski. Wait, I'm going to spell this wrong. Bob Osinski has a dope mixing program a lot of people overlook. And I think it's called, let me figure out what the heck it's called. Now, he writes a lot of books about mixing and mastering and all these type of things. But I would recommend his video course. I don't know if he still has it available, though. Oh, it's called 101 Mixing Tricks. So I would recommend that one. I'm going to rebuy that today. Mixing Primer Basics. So he has a bunch of stuff. Lastly, there's another website from Michael White. I think his name is Michael White Mixing. I could be wrong with the name. Yeah, Mixing with Mike. So he's super thorough with mixing as well. He has a YouTube channel. The only thing is remain completely open until this crisis. Okay. So the only thing is he teaches on Pro Tools as well. And I think you can buy a bundle. It's a little confusing going to their websites because there's so much to look at. But I think you could buy a bundle on here. Let me figure out what the heck the bundle's called, though. It's called, I swear there's like a bundle. Wait, mastering courses monthly. This might be it here. Like, no, that's not it. Where is it at, man? I swear he had a thing that was like everything all in one. Maybe not. I'm going to have to email his people and see how to just buy it all at once. I'm more a fan of like buying everything in a bundle and just taking my time with it versus going through membership. I only like going into membership once I know that I'm ready for an ongoing learning process. So it's kind of confusing because he has a lot of products, but I would also check him out as well. So I like to study from everybody. I don't like to just take one angle of mixing. I think somebody asked, did I take the Timbaland course? No, I probably should buy it to support Timbaland, but the whole masterclass business model reminds me of Splice. And I think it's just kind of devaluing people who actually have, they could, like if Timbaland just came out with a course, put it up on his own website, I think it would have done crazy numbers without masterclass, but it is what it is. I went on a rant. I didn't realize we're about to finish this beat. Not a face that sees a prisoner. I keep a face that sees a prisoner. She got a taste, got a season. Hi, game. I hired a sound designer. Oh, sorry. I was looking at my keyboard. I was wondering where that light was coming from. Hi, game. I hired a sound designer to make a drum kit. And my question is, how can I verify that he didn't just copy and paste the sounds? What you want to do? I just asked an entertainment attorney about this on the phone earlier. It's called a certificate of employment. And basically what you want to do is you have to have proper paperwork, really, is what it comes down to. That's going to save your butt and it's going to save your customers. Actually, your customers won't really have any liability issues, but that's a, okay. So let's, I'll be quick about this. Again, I don't want to talk about this when people came here for FL, but if you plan on doing a sound pack, here's a couple things. Drums are part of that weird part about sound that is that blurry line. Like same with a fair use. Because with a drum, if I hit a snare drum on a Yamaha drum kit and record it into a microphone, and then somebody else uses it, the same Yamaha drum kit hits the snare at the same velocity, how can you own me hitting the snare of a Yamaha drum kit? So that's part of the issue that people have. The other part of the issue with drum kits is that, oh, shout out to Brian. He just emailed me. Let me see. It was Brian that told me about this. It was today. Yeah. So shout out to Brian. He put me onto the certificate of employment. It's funny because I just talked about him and he emailed me a second after I like thought about him. I almost read his email out loud. What am I doing? Definitely not something to do. Read an attorney's email out loud, as it says at the bottom of their emails. This email is protected by whatever, whatever. But what was I going to say, though? I forgot what I was talking about. It's that blurry line. You know, it's like who owns the recording of a Yamaha snare hit? So you have that debate. Then you have the debate about drum machines, like a Roland TR-808. If the drum comes from a synthesizer, you have that debate. Is it considered a hard form asset, like a definitive sound, or is it considered synthesis? Because you can't copyright synthesized sounds. Like, you can't copyright a wavetable, because if you copyright a wavetable, nobody can use wavetables, and there's nothing anybody can make. Whereas, you know, if it's a very, very specific sound, like the yeah-ho, that chant, that's very specific. So copyright itself is very blurry. But when it comes to sound, it's even blurrier. That's why a lot of people get away with selling drum kits that have the same sounds, because technically enforcing the copyright is like half impossible. Richana, because I want to just show where I learned from. I don't like to hold back information. You know, I feel like a lot of creators on YouTube, they tend to think everybody's competition, and that actually holds them back. You know, I think if you're into mixing, you're going to buy everything about mixing. You're not just going to buy my course. You're going to buy Bobby Ozinski's. You're going to buy Mixing with Mics. You're going to buy The Art of Beat Mixing, and you're going to buy Audio School Online, because you want to absorb so much knowledge from so many different perspectives. Same with me. I don't just buy one plugin from Isotope. I buy every plugin that ever existed into the thousands of plugins. So I mean, that's going to help you in business, is just realizing that, you know, trying to hold back from your, unless you hate the person or hate the business, there's no point in holding back information, because everybody's going to buy from them anyway. It's just a matter of time. What was I talking about? Oh, the drum kit. So MK, just make sure, I would just talk to somebody who can draft you up a quick little document that says, hey, you know, you agree, the sound designer, you agree that you own the sounds, and you agree that, you know, you have to put the liability on them because they're giving you the sounds. So I would just do something like that. But again, don't obsess about sound kits again, because when it comes to, like, it's so blurry, though. You know, if it's a drum break, like boom, boom, ch, boom, whoops. That's a weird sound. That was so weird. What key did I press? Anyway, I hit a random key on my keyboard. That was so funny. What was I saying, though? My brain just doesn't. Okay, so if it's a drum break, boom, boom, ch, boom, ch, you know, that's different, because that's considered a definitive creative piece. Like the Amen break that goes, how does the Amen break go? I don't want to play it because it might copyright strike the video. Not copyright strike, but copyright claim the video. But the Amen break is like, I forget how it goes, but you know, the Tupac. That's a notable sample. I guess to answer your question, I know I'm going on and on and on and on about this, but if you guys are going to make drum kits, single sounds aren't necessarily copyrightable. Like, psh is not copyrightable. If I just go psh. But if I do and it's the same exact sound, same timing and everything, then that's copyrightable. Or if I have, again, it's such a blurry area, because some companies don't even copyright their sounds, but some companies do. You have some companies who watermark their sounds, and, you know, but they have very specific effects on it. So I would just contact an expert to draft you a quick little contract, and that will protect you in the exchange. Where's a list of all the VST presets used in hit songs? I wish there was one big old list. So I'm looking to hire sound designers. So MK Rostrap, I'm actually looking to hire sound designers myself. So that's why I was so in that frequency already with you. And I'm looking for sound designers who not only do drum kits, I'm looking to partner with Big White Beats, if he's out there and listening, We definitely got to do something with Big White Beats, because BWB, people thought I was him. People thought he was me. And we might as well just, he has really dope drums. I try to have really dope content. There'll be a match made in heaven. And also, what was I going to say? I'm looking for sound designers who actually know how to sound design like sounds, not just drums, but sounds and cool stuff like that. So I'm looking to expand my sound design team. So I'll have more information as we go. And that will be an opportunity because, you know, it's going to be simple. So I'm talking too much. Which music genre do you think is going to dominate music in the future? In the forthcoming future, I think 808s are just going to live till 20 years. They're just the perfect bass. I don't think there can be any better bass than the 808. Here's my prediction. Trap's going to last until we have a new form of actually playing music. Like until 5.1 stereo becomes a thing, or like some new technology transforms the way we even feel music and hear it. Until that happens, hip hop's gonna run the ship until the new technology switches to where we're gonna have some type of, like, what do you think the next level of music consumption is? Not necessarily the music style, but the consumption. I think the next level could be like a form of surround sound, but something where you would feel it even when you're standing up. So I don't know if that would be like some kind of thing that, like, imagine a technology where your headphones were also listening to your shirt, which also listened to your jeans, which also listened to your shoes. And then, like, they had some type of vibration technology that the song, you could feel the whole song throughout your whole body. I think that's going to, it's going to be where people are going to appreciate other genres of music more, because it's going to have more of a harmonic vibe to it. Until then, I just don't see trap going away or hip hop falling off. Trap is considered pop music. And I just don't see the culture shifting anywhere from that, because Instagram is keeping hip hop on top as well with the luxury lifestyles and all that they show. Humanized choir sound, get better choir libraries. Like Spitfire has some really dope ones, but they're expensive, but Spitfire has better choir libraries. I wouldn't obsess about choir because it's one instrument that, you know, it's going to fight with the main vocal for one. And for two, with choir, you don't use it on every beat unless it's like your stamp. So it's one of those sounds you don't use a lot of. I'm trying to think which library. I think I picked the wrong. I meant to pick, I forget what I got here. Wait, orchestral swarm. That's not it. Strings. No, dang, I picked the wrong plugin. I meant to pick this other plugin called Sign Player. And they have a dope library. I think, where's 8DO? I think I'm missing a plugin. Where's my 8DO sounds? Wait, my 8DO library? Hold up, y'all. I'm having a random brain struggles here live. But I bought a library from 8DO and I can't remember what the heck it's called. I forget if it's a contact library or if it's a, I think I forgot to install something. You know when you buy something and you're like, I know I bought something else, but I can't remember what the heck it was. 5.1 stereo is like a surround sound type of stereo. Have you heard the genre Amapiano? No. Like, think about it. Historically, complex music was never popular. Jazz was never a hugely popular genre, even though it's the most complex genre in the world. It's because what makes stuff popular is that other people can do it. Like, people do the Dougie and all that because they figured out how to do the Dougie. But if they did some, like, dance moves that nobody can replicate, it's not going to become a popular dance because nobody else can do it. So that's why pop music is so simple and kind of vanilla, because you want other people to be able to do it. I bought the library called, Majestica. Dang, I didn't even realize. I never checked for it. Did not even check for this library. I'm glad you said something, because, like, I bought a whole library and forgot I bought it. Wow. But it should be on my system. I don't know if I downloaded it. Let's manage libraries, and I have to pull up native access and all this type of stuff. Let's see. Native access. Okay, so where is... I swear I installed it. Whatever. Hold up. I know I'm eating up time, so forgive me, y'all. This is such a side note, but you just literally reminded me I bought something and forgot I bought it. Yo. Oh, my gosh. I literally forgot to install it. That's crazy, man. If you never would have said that, I would have just went on with life as if I forgot. And it's like a $400 thing. Totally forgot I bought it. Right? Not a face that sees a prisoner. Keep a face that sees a prisoner. So let me pull up a choir. So these choirs sound better than your typical, like, oh, yeah. Hold up. Not a face that sees a prisoner. Keep a face that sees a prisoner. She got a taste, she got a face, she's living up. You know. It's kind of dope. I'm glad you said choir, because it kind of sounds dope in the background. Hold up. Let's record that. Like, if you literally would not have said anything, I would have completely forgot I bought that thing. Crazy. So I'm glad I read that chat. Shout out to you, though. 1, 2, 3. Not a face that sees a prisoner. Keep a face. Yeah, Celestial. I used to use that a long time ago. Celestial Library. You know, for you know, prisoner, stiff sees a prisoner. And face is if wrong note. Prisoner, can die. I don't use one shot, hold on with that. That was a dope addition. So I played one wrong note, I meant to wait. I'm going to play A sharp instead of A. This is just nice in the background. It adds a lot more emotion. So when you have a dope library, like a film score library, it gives you these sounds that sound a little bit more open. So if you're looking for a choir, look for those. I mean, Omnisphere has cool choirs and stuff. There's just a difference with people who develop contact libraries. They have a different way they approach sound. Which headphone is best for producing? You need some open back headphones, and you want to look for... Sennheisers are really good. Sennheiser HD 600s are what I use. I forget the price, but I think Realistic actually has a blog. If you go to the Art of Beat Mixing, go to soundoracle.net, actually. Soundoracle.net. And I don't know where his blog is, but let's see if we can find it. Tutorials and blogs, and then... I don't know where it would be, but he has something in here where he talked about which headphones are the best. So that's where they have the list of stuff. So just cycle through those, you'll find it. All right. So as you see with FilmScore, their libraries are $600. I don't know if I bought it at 600. I think it was on sale. So it was like three something. So that's why a lot of people don't get this FilmScore, but their sounds are way different than the plugins we get. Which have, I know what your shoes would be saying, Busy. My shoes? I don't know what they would be saying. What would my shoes be saying? How to record Shep 73? It's just, it makes your mic, here's what a 1073 sounds like. Hold on, let's pull it up. 1073 just makes you sound a little more bitey. That's how I describe it. And Shep 73 mimics what's called a Neve 1073, which is called a preamp, and a preamp takes a bland mic signal and it makes it more full and exciting. Neve starts with an N, so N-E, here we go. So what I'll do is I'll turn off my already existing preamp. So my mic's a little special. It needs a lot of check. It needs a, whoa, okay. Hold on, let me turn this thing down. My mic needs a lot of leveling. So in this case, let me just at least level it to a decent level. But let's say, how can I explain this without making, I'm trying to make sense. Okay, so with this plugin, it just makes your mic louder and it gives it like a bitier sound to it. So let's add that and then let's just turn it up a little bit. So now you can hear my mic has more of a grizzly bitey sound to it. It's more barky, like it sounds more bubbly. That's what the Neve 1073 does. It just makes your vocals sound a little more gritty. And that's what the Shep 73 is modeled after, is a Neve 1073. Whoops, wrong thing, hold up. Let's get my mic back to a decent level. Check, check, check. I forget where I was at. It's probably around there, 45 dB. But I have a certain mic that needs a lot of leveling. You are asking me some long questions that require long answers. I mean, 808 replaces normal bass just because it has more of an impact. But also keep in mind that Travis Scott bass is not necessarily an 808. Audio Technica, those are good for recording. The MTHX or whatever, the MT whatever's. You're asking me the hardest question. What's the best? Whenever you say what's the best, it's going to take me 20 minutes to answer. So I'm going to just refer you to my videos where I show you my options for what's the best. A loop to play with. You want to give the subscriber? Yeah, I'm going to send out, check your emails tonight. I'm going to send everybody the power pack again, just in case you didn't open your emails before. It's a bunch of loops that you can mess with. They're all royalty free. All the sounds are royalty free. And it's a bunch of sounds. I think it's like 50 gigs worth of stuff in there. What's the best site to download paid plugins for free? Well, I don't know what you're talking about. What did you think about Beyer Dynamics? I never used any. How to make vocals like so wide. Waves Doubler is good for that. But keep in mind, vocal recording is a technique. It's not a plugin. Microshift is cool from Sound Toys, but it's better to record two takes and just spread them stereo left and one right. That will sound cooler than a plugin. Just doing multiple takes. Because I used to think as a very, very beginner, back when I was 14 years old, 15 years ago, I used to think that I could just record one vocal and then add a plugin and make it sound like I recorded 10 times. And that's just not what the plugins do. Like a vibrato. Would you ever think of dropping a one-shot kit? Oh, you asked me about one-shots earlier. One-shots, I tried to use them once, but just didn't come out sounding very good. It's hard to make it sound good. So why the choir is a build-up element? Let's spice this up with some reverb. So right now the levels are too high. We need to turn it down. For these drums, we're not gonna add hard trap drums. I wouldn't overly do piano. Piano's about how it's recorded. It's not really the plugins you add on it. It's not much to add to a piano except the compressor, maybe. And a like something that takes out the low mids just to take out the mud. You really don't need to do much to a piano unless you're trying to do like trap effects, which is different. In that case, you would add all your favorite things like halftime, gross beat. This one does not need gross beat and halftime because it already sounds good. Here's halftime. This doesn't sound right. Because there's already a lot going on. You don't want more things bouncing around. Let me finish this idea because I've been talking my head off for like 20 minutes. So we need like boom, very short drums. Let's see if we can find some octave drums. Actually, let's Drumify, I think I heard one in here. That's definitely a Drake production. We need like a... So this track, you don't want a lot going on because it distracts from the vocal. Pretty much done. That's what I said. When you work with loops, the track is done. It just needs a loop and a vocal. Really doesn't even need drums. And you're done. And it's like, now on to the next idea. So that's the power of using loops. It saves you a bunch of time. Boom, click, doom, doom, click. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, boom, boom, 3, 4, doom, doom. Okay. Let me stop playing. Okay. Let me draw that in before I forget. So when you're stuck, do the Timbaland thing, beatbox it out. So boom boom chikum boom. So I could draw it out on the piano. So it's G and it's, wait, G, C, which is the fifth. So boom, 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 boom. Let's record that. I played the wrong key at the end. I should have played instead of G, I should have played, I think, A flat, I think. It should have been the last note instead of A. This, let's hit shift down. Let's hit, what is it? Alt, Option, Q, and then let's hit Command down twice. Oh, you know what? I had to highlight it. Let's hit Option, Q again. And hit Command down twice. Even one more time, Command down. Now we're in the sub octave. To reset the volume, let's hit Option, left click. I like this bass a little bit better than the 808. Oh, you were saying sine bass earlier, true. So shout out to you. This is simple. Simple bass. It has the body of an 808, but it doesn't have the impact of the 808. Okay. So we don't want to make it overly hi-hats and like, because that doesn't fit the vibe. So let's bring in the bass over time. You could finesse it right here. You can play basically C minor. If you wanted to. I like Ableton. Maybe we'll do Ableton next. Wait, a couple of these notes are a little bit off. Hold up, let me fix that. Wait, one of the notes is off. Let's find it real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This one right here. Here we go. Let's hit Option, left click, drag it over. Hit Shift. Oh wait, not Shift. Command. Option, Q. Quantize. So see how it's just without autotune, it sounds pretty interesting. But the thing is, the bass is too loud, so it's taken away from the vocal. So this, I forget who asked the question, but you asked me which instruments, like how do I understand the frequency gaps or something. I forget the question. But you have to understand when you pick instruments, if I have a bass vocal that's going and then I have a bass guitar that's going boom 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 boom, they're gonna clash. So I have to either lower the volume of the bass or lower it down an octave so that it's in the subcategory to where it's not boom boom, to where it's boom boom boom. It's like a one lower. So I could lower the bass one more octave down. Let's see what that would sound like. Command or control down so that it's only a sub bass. This could work, but it's hard to hear. Let's pull up. I think this is a decent octave, but it does get in the way of that vocal, so you just gotta be careful though, because they have frequencies that overlap. So let's pull it down an octave. And now the bass can live alongside the vocal because they're not fighting for the same frequency space. So half the battle with mixing is putting stuff in the right frequency pocket to where it doesn't even clash to begin with. But there's ways to resolve like frequency clashes. Oh wait, that's the wrong... Wait, where's our vocal? Hold up, I lost our vocal. Vocal's on track of 5. So what I'm gonna do with the vocal is cut out more of the low end. Maybe add a compressor here. Let's do 2:1. This is just to thicken out the vocal a little bit. Also, there's like a... Okay, I know I'm moving a little bit quickly here, but if you boost this point, which is just an EQ point, and then what you do is you sweep your frequency. So turn this up and then move your frequency knob around until you hear where it gets like boomy and muddy. So let me exaggerate it. So it's around 300 hertz where it gets kind of muddy and blurry. So let's, instead of boosting now, let's cut that frequency. So now it becomes more clear because now we took away that muddy frequency. Wallities, I'm probably saying that wrong, says, how can I detect the difference between normal mic and expensive mic? Some people do mic shootouts, they're called, online. Check those out. I need to use extra plugins to analyze the spectrum. I would just watch YouTube videos on the mic shootouts because they do the hard work. You don't need to. The only way to test audio interfaces is in person. The only way to test microphones is, again, in person or through a mic shootout video. Live at the Barbecue says, do you think you'll ever switch up the beat critique submission like to non-description? Wait, to a non-descript email for those of us who don't use Facebook? Nah, because what it does, we did that before, and Google would literally shut down the email, and we couldn't do the feedback, because we had so many submissions. I think the email has like 8,000 emails in it right now, and I had to pay for like extra storage, because so many people sent emails in at one time, and it shut us down. So that's, even Gmail shut us down, so that's why we did the Facebook thing, because I guess they consider it like spam or something, I don't know what to. So that's why we can't do the email thing. We get too many submissions. Just make like a burner Facebook account. Just make a fake email, make a fake thing, and just make a fake thing. I've seen people on Facebook with like the weirdest names, like their first name would be Busy and then the last name would be Works. So I've, you know, people are getting away with making up names. I think you can too. I might add like a... It's hard to hear this low. I know people hate Facebook. You don't want them to have your data and all that. But we tried the email thing and it got out of hand. Only other solution I could think of is an equivalent to a Facebook group, which is our premium membership community thread, but it's not as easy to use as Facebook groups. So that's the only reason why. Maybe we'll do like the super chat button. I don't know how to turn on my super chat. I think they took it away on my channel. It just gives me a subscription button. I don't think I have super chat anymore. The only other way I could think of it is like do a super chat button to where I would do super chat and then your YouTube would pop up. We would copy and paste your YouTube or whatever it is, SoundCloud, and then do it that way. That's the only other way I can think of.
Not a face that sees a prisoner. I keep a face that sees.
Let's switch up the environment here.
She got a taste, got a taste, singing up. For you, love, for you, love.
Let's go hall reverb. Let's do like a cathedral.
Living faces, if it sees a prisoner. Getting guys, if it sees a prisoner.
So this computer, I mean, this piano needs a little bit more taming. We could do a multi-band compressor, but again, I don't have my isotope stuff, so I have to load up my Universal Audio stuff. But I don't, wait, yeah, I don't, yeah, true. Plus they track like the websites you go to. Facebook has everything on everybody. They know everything we do all the time. They have 52,000 data points on everybody. That's crazy. 52,000. I don't even know 52,000 things that I do. But they know. Facebook knows. And they sell it to marketers. That's what they do. All right. So what am I looking for? A multi-band compressor. Multi-band. Here we go. Where's our vocal? Five. Oh no, piano. We need it on the piano. So I know I'm doing a lot of random stuff. Some parts are mixing, some parts aren't. But when you're making... Whoa, my voice is super delayed. So since the delay is my voice, we're not going to do it that way. Huh. What is a multi-band? I don't know any other multi-bands. But the piano definitely needs taming on certain frequencies.
Not a face that we see.
Let's just add... Dang, I really need my plugins. This is crazy.
Not a face that
what I'll do right now to tame is just lower the volume. Julian King, do you have a YouTube channel? Is Julian... I'm on lockdown anyway, so I'm on my computer all night. I'll just make a video showing my desktop or something, then I'll upload all the files to a site where you can download them. I'm missing the conversation here. What about having the lower and higher octave together for the bass? Lower and higher. Interesting. You can do that, and it creates a unique wobble for 808s. You can stack 808s, believe it or not, but the notes have to be the octaves. So try stacking your 808s. It creates a cool, unique, like rumbly sound. The reverb on the mic maybe fill them in tunnel. Yeah. Oh, especially with the cathedral. The cathedral reverb. Let me turn that down a little bit. All right, so let me just finish this basic idea. All we gotta do last is the drums. Thing is, I don't know if you can hear the sub bass on phones. So that could be our rhythm. But I don't have those samples. So let's move a little bit quicker with the drums. I mean, I'm pretty sure you understand how to make drum rhythms. Basic drum rhythm. Let's see if we can find that. Wait, no, still the wrong pitch. Let's see if we can find that. Man. That's the tone I need. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, boom, boom. Wait. This, no. Boom, boom. We need a boom. This could work. Let me try this. We need to retune it though. Boom, boom. A little aggressive on the sound though, but this is close to what I was trying to get. We need a doop 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 doop. Not sure that would work. Nah, it's not the exact sound. This could work too. I think I'm spending way too much time looking for this sound, y'all. Oh, this is it right here. This is the exact sound I was looking for. So it needs to be dum 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 dum. Wait. Mm mm. Oh pattern mode. It needs a little more like swing to it. So go to your graph editor, go to shift, and then turn up shift for that last note. Let's see what this sounds like. It probably sounds crazy in the beat. Reminds me of like a Kanye West. Shout out to Kanye West for that. What's your favorite Kanye West album? Mine is Graduation and 808s and Heartbreak. Not 808s and Mermaids. 808s and Heartbreak. It's my favorite Kanye West album. But 808s and Heartbreak had the best melodies.
Wait, hey, 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 don't say you will unless you will.
Yeah, that was a crazy album. Oh my gosh. That was back when Gears of War came out too. Boom, boom, chick, boom, boom, chick, boom. Kanye West is just a genius, man. The Life of Pablo. I forgot about that one. That was kind of like a mixtape for Kanye. I feel like people just kind of skipped over that one. You rarely hear about The Life of Pablo. Guys, headed to a billion, so you really can't talk about it now. I didn't found your YouTube channel. Are you looking up somebody on the YouTube? Some of you just get these drums tight. Question is, do we need a kick? I'm not sure. I think a kick would make this too aggressive. Actually, this kick makes it soft. This is how you make drums, by the way. You guys are, you know, this is the secret. I'm gonna do another vocal. Make this like a Kanye West thing. This could make sense, it could not. Let's see. I gotta have a phrase. Every night at night, Benny, you're telling me y'all. Maybe at a night at night, you're telling me y'all. Let's say that. I know that was, it's more of a rhythmic background vocal, as you can tell probably. And I'm all out of key. If I solo this, it probably sounds so bad. Only off note was the beginning because I had to get used to it. I don't know how people did it without autotune back in the day. Like, how? Shout out to everybody multitasking, cook it up at the same time. We're cooking up at the same time.
talking about it, so you decided to tell him no. Getting tired, so you see this, if it's a no. Find your love, I'm serious, I'm serious, if it's a no. Never dreamed, never serious, if it's a no.
Usually when you have two contrasting vocals, you want to make sure that you contrast them EQ wise so that you can tell the difference, but I'm rushing with the mixing, so just keep that in mind. So what you would do is you EQ that one differently so it doesn't blend in with the other one, because then you can't, then you're, they're competing for the same space. Sub bass is starting to match with the kick now, so. I think the bass seems like it plays faster at a certain point. Yeah, let's re-quantize this. I think one of the notes was off. Everything, you see how everything's kind of loud? This is why your beats sound muddy too, is because everything is loud. So this is the point where I would turn my headphones up and then turn stuff down. So let's start doing that now. And this is just going to help you, help you gain stage, but I don't want to sound like geeky. This is going to help you get rid of muddiness. Why this plugin's not showing up on the list, because it's on here, it's just not showing up. So let's figure out why this could potentially be happening. So we go to more plugins and we scroll down to VST and we see the Thermionic Culture Vulture and we clicked the star button. So I'm trying to figure out why it's not popping up. Maybe it has to be AU, I don't know. Let's just try the AU version of it. Thermionic Culture Vulture, TH, here we go. If it doesn't show up now, then I don't know why. All right, so apparently the AU version, this is weird. I don't know, because XL has some stuff that's via, what, in the Heezy? No, let's not use that. FL on the Mac is a little quirky. Darn, this is my favorite plugin. We can't use it. Hold up a second, I'm confused. So the AU one, so Dreamverb is an AU. All right, the SSL channel strip works fine. Make it mono, whatever, FL's tripping. Now it shows up. Random glitch, I guess, I don't know, whatever.
across the streets, pressing on. Loving across the streets, pressing on. Getting close to the streets, pressing on. Find your love.
One of these notes is off, so let me get the timing right, because it's throwing me off. You can see as I pull the octave up, now everything's competing for that same space. Oh, here it is. I didn't notice that was off. To Alt, Option, or Alt, and then hit Option Q just to re-quantize it. This note's off too. Didn't even see that. Make sure the notes are a little bit longer. I know I'm speaking Japanese, so my brain works. So boom, boom, boom. Again, it's kind of hard to hear. Let's pull it up an octave. Now we have to determine which octave is best for the bass.
Not a face that sees a prisoner. I keep a face that sees a prisoner. She got a taste, got a face, looking up. You know.
I ate sour Skittles earlier. I haven't had cake in a while. I'm trying to think of the last time I had some cake. What kind of cake was it? I can't even remember the last. Oh, you know what? My mom made some like vanilla, some kind of vanilla icing cake. I like homemade cakes the best. Those like bakery cakes, the icing is so thick sometimes. Busy. Oh, the morning show on IG. Shout out to you for watching that. Appreciate it. This morning I was kind of struggling. I'm like, crap, what is there to even talk about? I talked about everything already. I didn't even know what to talk about. So I had to walk a little bit to think about some stuff.
Not a face that sees a prisoner. I keep a face that sees a prisoner. She got a taste, got a face, looking up. For your love, for your love.
Auxes are a little bit different in FL. If you click on any track you want, just click the up arrow. And that will send it to another track. And then you can left click this little knob and move it around. I think my head's in the way. But if you click another track, a little arrow at the bottom, it sends a duplicate to a different track, and then you click the up arrow to get rid of it. FL is a little bit different in the way they handle mixing compared to every other DAW. Let's get these drums and everything, because there's a lot going on. We have the vocals, we have the bass, a lot to mix. I'm not going to waste time mixing everything. I just want to get at least the levels right. The beat still needs like a something that'd be like rhythmic. Now for this percussion, it actually needs to be a little bit earlier than the beat. So here's a trick I use sometimes, hit Option Left to pull it a little bit ahead of the beat. Sometimes, like for Timbaland style tracks, you need to kick a little bit earlier. Not sure even. I think I just pulled it back to where it was. But he's like, so I could, I know I'm like all over the place. Hold on. I probably could do a do. Wait. Let's try it. One, boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. So, just repeat that. See how it adds that, the contrast rhythm? Let's try it. It may sound cool, may not. But see, at a certain point, it kind of goes out of the groove. And here's where we could either use the shift to kind of make a unique bounce with it, so it doesn't sound so like it gets off a groove after a while. And I think it's because of, I think we did this earlier in the beat, but I forgot what we did it on. So it needs that swing, but the problem is it needs to come in a little bit early. But see, now so many things are going on that we need to simplify it. So now we can hit option left. This needs to be like one step earlier than the beat. Here's the trick too. Hit Alt F or Option F in this case to do the flam tool. So it was bleep. This one you can't really hear, so let's turn the volume up. Wait, hold up. Here goes. I wonder why you can't hear it in the context. Probably so much going on. But now you can hear it now that you have focus on it. But there's a lot going on, so we need to level. One thing to make stuff sound separate is pan it out. Now, luckily in FL Studio's piano roll, I know I'm moving really, really fast, so I'm just trying to get the track done. Or at least to a decent degree. So we can do the panning inside of the piano roll. So I wanted to do left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right. So let's do that. And you could do it just left clicking these pan values and change your control to pan. So left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right. And it also creates like a stereo effect, which is useful. Now, drawing these in. It's weird because I can hear it louder in my right ear, so let's make it pan left harder. Let me turn the vocals off for a second. Realize we're trying to match that piano movement. Do I want it at this lower octave or the higher one? just trying to see if it has less conflict than the lower octave. See, when you stereo imaging, you could do a lot of so much with mixing. That's why I said I don't want to confuse you guys to death, but you can actually have stuff coexist using mid and side stuff. Just getting inspired from what you're doing. Oh, awesome. Julian Gaye. See, now this octave sounds way different because of the chorus. Now that I have this cool sound, I'm going to do a weird pitch bend, like something like that. Notice how I'm only adding all this rhythmic stuff after the vocal, because now I know how much space I actually have to do bass stuff. But if you overly do bass stuff before the vocal, you could not leave enough room. Now it's, the bass is moving a little too much. So there's a creative side and then there's a technical clashing side. Does anyone know if you can, if you can't change the pitch bend range in Ableton Standard? I'm asking because it doesn't have the sampler and that's how people do it. But that's a very Ableton question. Any Ableton pros in the chat? So if you want the bass to shine, just take out your drums during that section. So I want it to shine during that beew at the end. So I'm going to take out the drum. Accidentally dope. I don't know if I moved something to overlap, but that sounded super dope. It was like boom, 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 boom. No, I think it was over here. No, I think the kick lined up perfectly. Where was it at? Let's make that unique. And that was one of those happy accidents when you accidentally do something, but it sounds dope. Now the question is, where's the kick track? I think it's 7. Yeah, it's 7. So let's make that unique. And then where it goes boom, 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 make sure the kick lines up. So it's 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I think that's what. There's one thing going too many, and I think it's the piano. But we need the piano. That low end of the piano is just like the extra thing that's being too much movement. So I don't want to get rid of the whole piano. Let's see if we EQ out the low end. That's why I said you can have too many things going on. So there's a lot going on in this track. What does your FL Master's Guide course cover? Basically how to jump into FL for the first time and just navigate like you know what you're doing. So you don't waste time watching a bunch of tutorials about every little thing about FL. The main problem about FL is everybody shows you stuff you're never going to use ever. And it's, you might, like FL comes down to these buttons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's all you have to know about FL is these 5 buttons. So the FL Master's course shows you how to use these 5 buttons to navigate through FL and actually make stuff from there so that you're not looking at all these features you're never going to use. Like, when are you going to use Patcher? You know, rarely. So stuff like that you're not going to use. What's your module and what does buyers expect to gain? How many modules, maybe you're asking? I think it's 12. I forget the specifics, but it's a 12-hour course. It is, for the specs and time and all that, it's on the page. We're redoing all our pages, though, to give you more information. But what it really is, in a nutshell, is guiding you through how to jump into FL if you know nothing about it and how to maneuver like you do know something about it. So it's going to save you a lot of time, basically, running through tutorials. That's what it's for. So it's trying to figure out the element we can take out that will just make this sound more, less busy. So maybe like, let's add gross beat. I think I have an idea. All right, let's add gross beat and let's mask like half of it. So make it go dun, 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 and then go mute so that it doesn't occupy. Here's what I'm trying to say. So it's only dun, 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 and that way it's not so all the way through. I don't know why people are obsessed with LUFS. Just make your beats and export them. Nobody is sitting there like, yo, how many LUFS does this have to be? Especially if you're making beats that aren't songs, because LUFS, you're not trying to max out your LUFS as a beat. People are not trying to blow out their eardrums to a beat. So that's, don't obsess about that. How do you work with LUFS, TruePeak, and RMS? Maybe you're just trying to learn what LUFS is, but in FL Studio, they don't have those meters by default. You have to buy something like Isotope Plugins, Tuska, Musicas. How do I find the right key for the 808s? Type in Tuning BusyWorks Beats, and you'll find a video. So getting rid of that second vocal will definitely help. And then what I'll do is get rid of the bass line for this half. So we'll have the da 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 be the bass line. See, getting rid of that busy vocal and the busier choir, which are two vocals, it freed up a lot of that confusion. Gross beat is for quick little stutter stuff. And halftime, I don't have it on this computer, but it's just to slow the melody down. It's almost like slow motion for video. But see how the piano's like. When you're first starting, just learn as much as you can. Whatever you like to learn. Because that's the key. You got to find stuff that you actually like to learn. Then over time, you'll piece all of it together. There's no one way to go about anything. Let's play from the beginning. Not a face that we see. Oh, in the beginning, I guess we have to take off Gross Beat because it's more of a performance. So let's turn it off in the beginning and then on when the 808 drops or when the kick comes in. Make sure our snap to grid is on bar. Let's go back. Hit play. Not a face that we see, a prisoner. I keep it face that we see, a prisoner. She got a taste of the Or you could do the Drake underwater effect, which is take out the highs. That'll make it less busy as well. But then you're taking away part of the melody. You can hear the Mac in the background. It's like, psh, listen to the computer noise. That's why you guys gotta have a separate recording section if you can. Just step away from your computer. You can't EQ out the noise of a computer in the background. So it's gonna add a lot of noise that you don't want. Make it more cinematic. There's so many like decisions that are based on other decisions. So when we take out the high end, then the bass doesn't sound right because there's no counterbalance for it. So a lot of decisions that you have to make creatively and mixing. Like the lower octave bass, but then you can't hear the musicality of it. So there's so many micro decisions that once you make a decision, you have to go back and change a bunch of other stuff. This is usually the problem us producers have. If you make a dramatic change, not even a dramatic change, but if you make a rhythmic change, then you have to go back and change everything that ties to that one thing. So it becomes like a balancing act at this point. And this is more about, this is more of the arrangement mindset than actually, okay, here's the intro, here's the chorus. It's about balancing out stuff rhythmically. Live at the BBQ says, how do you get to where you can set the mix level in the track like that? What do you mean? Like how much time, or do you mean, how do you get to where you can set the mix level in the track like that? You talking about these knobs right here? I'm not sure you can hide or reveal these knobs, but I'm trying to understand your question. How do you get to where you can set the mix level in the track like that? The mix level in the track like that. Not sure what you're Okay, you mean Gross Beat? Gross Beat, where is Gross Beat? Gross Beat's over here. Gross Beat has two main sections. You have a green section, and then you have like a yellow section. So green refers to the time, yellow refers to the volume. So if you click on, the thing is, it's weird because you don't know, people don't know how to go between the two. There must be like a button. Yeah, okay, so the button down here cycles between the two. So if you want to mess with the volume, click on the little volume icon here and it will switch the screen to volume. But if you want to mess with the time, you would click on that little clock icon. And then that's how you do that. And you said, how do you create automation? You right click on the knob here, go to create automation clip. And then you right click points in. They're called nodes. You right click if you want to make a point. right click delete if you want to delete a point. I would recommend you put your snap to grid on bar mode. It just makes automation a lot more easy. So I have a lot going on. So this track is like, I have to revisit it so that I can come back with a fresh, definitive ear that says, here's what's out of place. Because there's something that's making it over the top. And I can't figure out exactly what element it is. It's probably the piano because there's two parts gone. But, you know, I wish I could separate the high end from the low end and just separate those out. But it is what it is. How long have we been going? I feel like it didn't feel like a long time streaming, but I feel like we've probably been on here for like 5 hours. Hold up. We've been on here for 3 hours. It does not feel like that. I want to make one more track and just, I'll be quick about the next one though. Again, if you're watching the replay, my mic's super loud now, huh? Hold up. If you're watching the replay, go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio to enter the FL Studio giveaway. Okay, because we're going to pick the winner live tomorrow, Friday, 9 p.m. Eastern time. We're going to pick the winner live, and we're also going to do song feedback as well. And what else do I have to tell you? So that's what we're going to be doing tomorrow. But make sure you enter because we're only going to pick from the people who entered. What else? You want to do Ableton? Somebody said I don't show love to Ableton anymore. Is some benefits to rewire between $2? Nah, I wouldn't do that. It's just rewiring is if you want to use some kind of Ableton plugin, but in FL Studio, like maybe a Max for Live device or something like that. It's better that you just stay within the DAW, in my opinion. Rewiring is really convoluted most of the time. Because you have to understand signal flow, and then you have to understand, like, how do you recall a project that has a rewire? So it's a lot of nuances to it. Keyscape? I don't have Keyscape on this computer. I need to download it on here. I have it. I bought it, but I just don't have it on this computer. So we're looking at stock stuff. I put a beat on my YouTube, and I think I'm going to remake it with what I just learned. Shout out to you. I know, like, music production is like, once you learn something new, you want to go back to all your old beats and apply it to all your old beats. Like, if you learn a mixing trick or you learn something, you just want to apply it to everything else. I remember that same feeling of being like, oh man, I just learned how to do whatever, whatever. I need to go back and fix everything. So that's the infinite kind of loop about learning mixing. You're going to want to fix everything. But it can get a little brain crazy because music is always fixable. There's no perfect ending for a song. You're always going to want to tweak it some type of way. Even creatively. Even if it's mixed perfectly, you're going to want to creatively mess with it. How do you get to where you can... We got a lot of people here. Do you want to like investigate a new DAW? Like Ableton, you want to look at Logic? A lot of you didn't watch the Logic stuff, so I assume you're over the Logic thing. I'll still do videos for Logic, but we could do Ableton remix contest. I got to give y'all better heat than that one. That was kind of... I'll send you all the loops tonight. Actually, it's kind of late. So what I should do is send everybody the loops before it becomes super late to where people won't even check their email. So I'm going to do that now. And I don't want to end the live stream, but kind of have to because I have to send out emails. This is where I wish I had like somebody sitting right here where I could be like, okay, let's send some emails. Here's what I want to say. Hey, I just kind of downloaded FL. Any tips how I start making with beats? If you're on our email list, you want to check your email tonight, because the thing with FL, it's a great DAW to learn how to make beats in, but the stock sounds are not that great. So you're going to be trying to make stock sounds sound good for the rest of your life when you could just get good sounds from the start, and it saves you a lot of like mental energy. Other DAWs have really good stock sounds by default, most of them. Logic Pro X probably has the best stock sounds. So what I'll do is end this stream, unfortunately, because I have to write emails. It's almost 9 p.m., so I have to write emails. Check your emails. I'm going to send everybody the power pack, and I'm going to send the people who did the survey the, the exclusive loops. And what else do I have to tell you? And I'll just be doing a bunch of admin stuff. All right, so check your emails tonight, and that's all I got to say. I got to wrap it up because of time, not because I want to, but because of time. But all right, thanks guys for hopping in. Appreciate you.